What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to Wimbledon. It's day number 7. And it's already started. We've already got matches happening. And it's going to be an interesting day. Fourth round action. The last of the early rounds. Quarterfinals start tomorrow. So it's going to be interesting. I'm interested to see how it plays out. Because I think, as we've seen throughout the whole tournament, that there's a lot of kind of random players in this stage of the draw. There's probably about two players on the men and the women's side that we expected to be here, but there's a lot of randoms. So we're going to talk about all the randoms. We've got Diminor. He's up 2-0. Great day for the Aussies. We've got 4 Aussies in action today, so I'm super pumped for that. Of course, we're watching Kyrgios here against Nakashima, but Diminor, he's up 2-0 and 4-0 in the third. We've got, who else is coming on? Rabakin is on right now as well. Oh, I forgot my glasses. That's what I forgot to put on. There we go. That's better. Rabakin is on right now against Martic. We've got Badosa versus Halep coming up after this. And then Rafa's coming on later. It's going to be a big day. Big day and a big day for the Aussies because we've got 4 Aussies in action. We've got Diminor winning now. We've got Kyrgios, Kubler, and Tomjanovic. So 4 Aussies all trying to get into the quarters. And if Nakashima and Kyrgios, if this match goes the way of Kyrgios, it could be a Diminor-Kyrgios quarterfinal. And that's an all-Aussie affair. And look, what's better than 1 Aussie? 2 Aussies. It means we're going to get an Aussie in the semis, which is insane. How are we all doing? How have we been? What's been up to? I've been asleep, so that's what I've been up to. Let's get to the preview, because the players should be out on court very soon. These two players have never played before, as you'd probably expect. Relatively young players, and I'm really excited to watch Nakashima in the flesh, because I've been pumping up this guy for a while as one of the next Americans to watch, and I've been hearing a lot about this American as well. So you can see there, Nakashima. He has gotten through his match in the last round in straight sets. Nakashima's road to this stage has been... Where are we? He beat Kun in the first round in 4 sets. He beat Chapo, which was the big win, in 4 sets in the second round. Beat Gallen, and then, of course, is playing Kyrgios. Kyrgios' road. He beat Jubb in 5 sets in the first round. He beat Krajinovic in straight sets in the second round, and then, of course, beat Tsitsipas in the circus match the other day. Winner of this will play Diminor or Garin, who are playing at the moment. Let's talk about Brandon Nakashima, 56 in the world. He is 20-year-old from America, and as I've said, this guy, I've heard good things. This guy, it might be the hope of American male tennis. I think there's a lot of guys that could be that, but this guy is apparently the one that everyone's kind of, a lot of people pumping up. 6'2", right-handed, 12 wins, 13 losses on the year. No titles to his name yet. Still young. But he's got some good wins over Pear and Fanini, a couple of veterans. Nick Kyrgios, world number 40. Unfortunately, could have been maybe top 20 had he had this been worth points. Unfortunately, that's not the case. 27-year-old from Australia. He's 6'4", right-handed. 16 wins, 6 losses on the year. Remember, didn't play any of the clay court season because of the fact that he doesn't like playing on clay. Basically, no titles this year, but he has got 6 career titles. Best wins are against Rude and Rublev. Now, these two have never played. I don't think that's a surprise, but this is going to be intriguing. Kyrgios gave a lot of respect after his last match to Nakashima, saying this guy is not one to be overlooked, because everyone was talking about, oh, you're going to make the semis now. I mean, everyone else has dropped down. You're the guy. He's like, I'm not looking past the next guy. So, you know, Kyrgios saying the right things, you know, for once in the press conference. And I'm interested. Nakashima on, you know, 4th of July. Happy 4th of July, everyone out there as well. I'm sure no one's awake. Oh, unless you guys wake up early and start drinking beers in the first thing in the morning. But I'm keen. I'm keen for this one. Now, I don't think we're going to get the circus we got the other day. The center court, They're not going to stand for that. The circus on court number one, of course, we expected that because court number one, we know, is a easier court to get into for the average person. Let's just leave it at that. Gives more money for the beers. But center court, they're not going to get involved. And that's what happens at the Australian Open. Rod Laver Arena, when Kyrgios plays on Rod Laver, it doesn't get the same madness as he does when he plays on the other courts at the Australian Open. So I'm not expecting too much of a circus. Obviously, trick shots. Obviously, probably arguing with the umpire. Just the usual Kyrgios stuff. But I'm not expecting the craziness we had the other day. The other day, that's not going to fly on center court. No way. No way. By the way, I'm just having a look at a Twitter update saying that Wimbledon Chiefs refused to move forward the schedule of play despite Djokovic and Murray concerns. We have had some long matches, longer than anticipated. Oh, yeah. I mean, well, yesterday they started at 2 o'clock in the afternoon, didn't they? And then Djokovic finished at like nearly 11. So, yeah, it's been a hectic tournament. It's, I guess, you know, traditions, they're not going to break tradition, are they? So the Demon, he is at 5-4 down in the third, but he's up 2 sets to love. Keeg's coming on in a minute. Let's answer some questions.
Answer my question! The question, jerk!
Very quiet. All right. How we doing? How we doing, everyone? I want to see tennis, not a circus. It won't be a circus, don't worry. This will not be a circus. Just the Kyrgios antics, you know, Kyrgios will be Kyrgios, but Nakashima won't play into it, and the crowd won't be as crazy as the other day. And again, happy 4th of July to everybody out there. Hopefully you're having a good one. Well, starting a good one. What's with my voice? I've been talking for 2 weeks straight. Then this is how it sounds. I don't know what you want from me. I've been streaming for 12 hours a day for weeks. So, I mean, my voice sounds like this because of that shit. But there you go. Who would have thought, eh? What are the chances of Nick winning Wimbledon? He's got to beat two goats to do it. So, not very good. You need a rest? I don't need a rest. It's all right. And also, I haven't spoken out loud since we went off stream the other, like, 12 hours ago. So, yeah. My voice is just warming up. We just need time to warm up. You need to shut up, like, for a few days. It's the only way to heal. Well, I can't do that. I don't have the luxury of not going live. So I'll get over it.
Your understated energy is incredible, mate.
Hey, thank you, Curved Glass, for the donation. Appreciate that. We have plenty of time not to talk after the tournament. This time next week, I'm a ghost. I'm gone. You guys won't be hearing from me for a long time. I'll disappear after next week. He has beaten both of them, yes. But the thing is, the reason why I don't think Kyrgios can beat Nadal and Djokovic is because Djokovic is a beast, and he's on grass. And I mean, he's not going to, like, get whooped by them, but I think he might get a set. But I think Nadal's got his number too. I mean, Kyrgios hasn't beaten Nadal for like 3 years. And he's done well against Rafa at times this year as well. But I just think Rafa's got the edge. Which is crazy to say because Rafa beats everybody else. And we have to say it's close with him, but it is. You know, that's the case. Do you think, what do you think about the Kyrgios stream? It's a scam. It's a scam. I've seen a lot of people talking about that. It is not Nick Kyrgios. It is a scam. So if you are seeing Nick Kyrgios streaming live, it's a scam. That is not Nick Kyrgios. That is someone who is playing a podcast from someone else that he is involved in on a loop. It is a scam. It is not Nick Kyrgios. If it was Nick Kyrgios, it would have the subscriber number. You'd see the subscriber amount, and it would also not have all the giveaways in the chat. Total scam. Don't be fooled. Not Nick Kyrgios. Yeah, it's been going for 10 hours. It's not Nick Kyrgios. If it was Nick Kyrgios, he would have been live. He wouldn't just be replaying a podcast he was on once upon a time. Yeah, it's a scam. Don't be fooled. Don't be fooled. Because I saw it too, and I clicked on it as well. Because I'm like, ooh, Nick Kyrgios behind the scenes Wimbledon. That sounds fun. He would be on Instagram. He wouldn't be on YouTube. So yeah, so do not be fooled. It is a scam. That's actually a podcast he was on like a month ago or 2 months, just before he came to Wimbledon. A podcast, I think it was called, I can't remember. It was a good podcast too. Go listen to the podcast, but do it on the actual channel. Don't do it on the scam site. Go watch the podcast on the actual guy's channels. Let me find it. I'm going to give him a massive shout out because I like what they did. And I liked that they had a really good conversation with Kyrgios and had had Kyrgios comfortable. Which is rare. You rarely see Kyrgios in a comfortable position. Turn up the talk. It's called Turn Up the Talk podcast. In fact, I'm going to put a link in the chat so you guys can go watch it. But yeah, that Nick Kyrgios stream is a total scam. Don't be fooled. Don't be fooled. It is not real. It is not real. Here you go. There you go. That's where the actual podcast is that they're scamming on the Nick Kyrgios YouTube channel, which is not really him. Anyways. What is the difference between a flick and a normal ground stroke? A flick is just when they kind of like flick the wrist, like a table tennis shot, like a little flick. Whereas a ground stroke's when they actually use their whole arm. A little flick. That's what a flick is. Keegs is playing in about 5 minutes. They're coming out on court in about 5 minutes. So stay tuned. They're coming on in a second. No ceremony today. No celebrations of anything. It's all tennis. In fact, they're on court right now. I thought Tsitsipas was a little sore and Keegs had valid points. Yeah, look, we spoke about this at length yesterday. Both were in the wrong and both had good points. I think they both, no one was right or wrong in that. It was about both. Like both had valid reasons to be upset and both had valid reasons to be, you know, that they made about the other person. But I think no one was 100% right or wrong in that thing. I think Kyrgios was wrong to say that Tsitsipas should have been defaulted. That was a little bit excessive. And I think Tsitsipas was a little bit, you know, over the top with his comments about, you know, everyone should have like an intervention with Kyrgios and tell him that his attitude is not good. I don't think any of that should happen. Did you see Pat Cash's comments about Nick? No. What was his comments? I just saw that video. I was like, Nick Kyrgios at Wimbledon already, yeah. Hey, what's up, Mario? Diminor is doing fantastic. Yes, he is. Yes, he is. The demon. Yes. Pat Cash bashing Kyrgios just now. Oh, was he? I don't know what it is. Am I always in the minority when there's arguments? I feel like I'm always on the minority side. You know, Djokovic gets banned from Australia. Everyone's celebrating, and I'm, you know, going into bat for how Djokovic should be allowed to play. You know, I'm on Djokovic's side, and then with this, everyone in Australia is bashing Kyrgios, and I'm like, you know, on his side. I don't understand. You have to be subbed for 5 years to talk in that chat. That's a scam. I told you, it's a scam stream. Don't get it fooled. Don't get twisted. That's a scam. Yeah, Steph, we got to 98K yesterday. It's crazy stuff. Aussies need a new slam champion. Think it can be Kyrgios. this is what's going to happen. Because we've got options, no, like, I reckon 90% of Australians don't want Kyrgios to win it. They'd rather with Dimonor. 90% would rather Dimonor because Dimonor represents Australia better than Kyrgios does. That's what it comes down to. All of this, all of the Australian, you know, all of the hate towards Kyrgios is because he doesn't represent the country well. That's what it comes down to. National pride. And Dimonor does. So more people would want Dimonor to win just because he represents Australia better. Not saying that is disrespectful way, but I feel that everyone overshadows Kyrgios' talents just because he's controversial. No, I think that's what it, I think it kind of feeds into that. So a lot of people are like, man, he's so controversial, but he's also so talented. Why can't he just focus on his talent? You know, that's what that's always seems to be the conversation too. Aussie would prefer Kyrgios over Tomic. Yeah, true. Yeah. Dimonor's a class act. Yeah, exactly. 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 Yeah. There's, I think, frustration that Kyrgios could be an Australian Grand Slam champion. That's the frustration. People get so annoyed that he could be that guy. And he's not. And he's wasting away, he's wasting his opportunities. But I've kind of come to the realization that he's never going to win a slam, and I'm just happy to watch him. I'm just along for the ride. And also, you know, there's obviously the argument that he's bad for the game and all that stuff as well. But we've talked about that at length the last couple of days. And I was actually thinking about it a little bit deeper today. Because there's an argument that Kyrgios brings the wrong type of fan. He brings in a type of fan that is going to poison tennis. That's what I've heard. To me, I see it like Kyrgios is going to bring in a type of... He's going to bring in fans, right? He's going to bring in random people that never liked tennis, never thought about tennis until he did some things. They come in for Kyrgios. He is the gateway, hopefully, for a lot of people to watch more tennis. Just like I hope that this channel is a gateway into a lot of people coming from Wimbledon and from the French Open and watching tennis all year round. So, you know, I hope, and I kind of hope for the best, that people come in for Kyrgios and watch his antics, but then they stay and they make, you know, maybe they end up watching, you know, Medvedev or Zverev or someone, or Alcaraz, and they stay and watch Alcaraz and they become a tennis fan. That's why, you know, he brings eyeballs to the sport. And I hope that some of those eyeballs stay. That's why I think he's good for the sport. Even though it's for the wrong reasons, you know. But, well, only time will tell. We don't want any random fans making noise in our sport. Yeah, but that's called gatekeeping. And tennis, and someone said this yesterday. You know, tennis has too many gatekeepers, you know, that we're like people sitting, you know, sitting at the gates saying, oh, no, you're not a tennis fan because you like Kyrgios, so you can't come in. And that stuffs up the sport. So, yeah, don't be a gatekeeper. You know, you shouldn't be like, well, you're only here to watch the carnage of Kyrgios. You can't be a part of our sport. Well, that's not fair. Gatekeepers, that's never a good thing in anything. You know, music, movies, sports. Anyways, we've talked about this at length. Now let's watch the man behind the controversy and the young man behind the American charge. Nakashima, he's up 30-love. Who's going to win this match? I've got a 5-setter. I don't know why. 4th of July, Nick Kyrgios. Nakashima's legit, and I've been pumping this kid up, having watched him a couple of times. And I think I've heard in America, he is the dude that is going to take American tennis by storm. And he's already in the 4th round with no one talking about him. So how do you like that? Brandon in 4, Kyrgios in 4. Okay. Again, happy 4th of July. I'm sorry that Nakashima fans, that you are not going to be able to celebrate with a win, but that's okay. You've got other players anyway. Fritz is probably going to beat up one of my guys, so that's all right. All right. And happy to, and Aussies, we are having a great day today. So many Aussies in this fourth round. First game goes to Nakashima. Great start. Love game to start. Keegs in three. Dimonor still playing, so we'll wait for him to do his thing. But I'm excited. It's going to be exciting. Rafa Kubler's quarterfinal. No, I think Kubler's had a great run, but I think Fritz gets him. Sarcasm alert. Ken, this morning you were making too much sense. Stop being right. Wait, was that sarcasm? So you think I'm not being right? Think I'm saying stupid things? Cam would have hated Nick if he didn't have the flag beside his name. Untrue. That's very untrue. That is untrue. 15 love. There's a bit of serve down tee, and that's a good serve from Kyrgios. 30 love. As we get another serve from Kyrgios. That's a fault. Second serve. Serve out wide goes to the slice of Nakashima. Backhand now slice from Nakashima goes into the forehand of Kyrgios, who hits it out. 30-15. But let me know in the chat, if you're from America, give us some insights into Brandon Nakashima. I've heard him mentioned as, you know, in the same breath as Korda, you know, as this guy that we all should be watching. He is likely to take over as and be a serious contender at Slams in the future. That's what I've been hearing. So let me know what you guys have been hearing on the American scene. If that's the vibe in America, if Nakashima is the next the great hope. I know Korda's, we all know Korda, but I think Nakashima's there too.
Cam loves Shopper, so take that.
Exactly, Diego. I also like Chapo. Anyways, slice there from Nakashima. 40-15. There's been a forehand now to the backhand of Nakashima, who puts it wide. 1-1. 1-1. I wonder if Federer is going to watch Keegs today, if he's still there. Yeah, look, I know people are going to say, oh, if he wasn't Australian, you wouldn't back him as much. Okay, well, why do I back Djokovic, even though people were crapping on him at the start of the year? I'm not Serbian, so I don't know. I think that's just a cop-out to say that. Bernard Tomic is Australian, and I don't want anything to do with that guy. So, but I don't know. You tell me. There's a bit of forehand now from Nakashima. That's a great shot from Nakashima. All right. 15 love. Now, I think we saw Nakashima play against Zverev, was it? At the French, perhaps? We saw Nakashima play somebody recently. Who was it? Does anyone remember the stream? Serve now from Nakashima is a fault. Second serve. Second serve into the backhand of Keegs. Slice from Nakashima to the backhand of Kyrgios. Again to the backhand of Nakashima. Backhand to backhand as Nakashima hits another slice into the forehand of Keegs, and that's a winner. Lovely winner there from Kyrgios, and it's 15-30. Sorry, 15-all.
Come on!
15-all. So yeah, Leighton Hewitt's watching Dimonor. And he's probably watching, going to go watch Kubler as well, because Leighton Hewitt is a Davis Cup captain, and he's recruiting. So he's watching all the Aussies except for Kyrgios, because Kyrgios doesn't play Davis, probably won't be playing Davis Cup. As we get a backhand now from Keegs down the line, it's wide. 30-15. It was Zverev? Okay, I thought it was. Yeah, and he didn't do great, but I don't think clay was his surface. Dimonor was in a tiebreak, by the way, against Garin in that third set. Serve is a Let. Yeah, happy 4th of July. 30-15. First serve in the net. Second serve. Nakashima out wide at the back of Kyrgios, and that's hit wide. 40-15. Quick start here for the boys. I feel like tie breaks will happen today. We will be getting tie breaks. Serve out wide. There's a fault. Second serve. There's a double fault from Nakashima. 40-30. Anybody in Melbourne got a spare heater? Can't help you, buddy. As Nakashima serves a fault. Second serve. Second serve into the forehand of Kyrgios. Forehand out from Nakashima to the forehand of Keegs. Again to the forehand of Nakashima. Hits it in the net. And we are a deuce. Nakashima under pressure here as he serves. A fault. Second serve.
Top boy, first serve.
Serve out wide to the forehand of Keegs. That goes in the net. Good second serve from Nakashima. And it's advantage advantage Nakashima. Advantage Nakashima. To take back the lead. Garen's trying to win that tiebreak, by the way, against Dimonor. Come on, Demon. Finish it off, mate. Serve into the forehand of Kyrgios. Back air now. But Kyrgios' return was out. All right. 2-1. Kyrgios is going to challenge, but Nakashima's pretty confident. All right. Is Cam drunk? Why would I be drunk? And that was wide. Okay. Why is Keegs not playing Davis Cup? So, yeah, I see a couple of people are questioning. So, when I say he's not... Layton's watching all the Aussies because he wants to see who can play in the Davis Cup team. Kyrgios is not committed to Davis Cup. That's what I meant to say. That he's not committed to Davis Cup. So, Layton doesn't want to rely on Nick Kyrgios to play Davis Cup and be like, okay, we've got Dimonor, we've got Kyrgios. Now we're just going to find the other guys. Leighton's watching, and he knows if Kyrgios is free to play Davis Cup and he wants to play, he gets an automatic entry because he's the best Davis Cup player we've got. But if Keegs decides not to play, which he, you know, I mean, he does, doesn't he? He just disappears. Leighton doesn't want to rely on that. So Leighton doesn't need to watch Kyrgios for Davis Cup, you know, for the Davis Cup, whatever, you know, Davis Cup qualification, whatever. So that's why Leighton won't be watching Keegs. But also he's watching Dimonor because Dimonor's his guy. Like Dimonor's his protege. You know? And then he'll go watch Kubler. He'll go watch Kubler because Kubler might be a Davis Cup, you know, member. And so he wants to go and check that out. But he never really watches Kyrgios. And also maybe Kyrgios doesn't want Leighton there. You know, like Kyrgios keeps his box small. Doesn't usually have excess people in there. And if Leighton wants to watch the match, he can watch it in the Royal Box anyway, because he's a beast. Former champion. All right, 30 love, Kyrgios. Quick. As he does another second serve, and it's another ace. Just demolishing his serve at the moment, Kyrgios. And underarm serve is a let. Already started it. Where's the bingo cards? Where's the bit? Hey, you know what? We're going to play Kyrgios Bingo today because we can. We're going to play Kyrgios Bingo. I've got to find the bingo card. All right, second serve goes to the backhand of Nakashima. Backhand from Keegs goes long. We've already got the underarm serve. Tick that off your card. Kyrgios Bingo. Let's get it. Let me find the bingo card. All right, Kyrgios. We haven't played bingo for a while. I feel like Kyrgios Bingo is perfect for today, especially for 4th of July. All right, second serve, Keegs into the backhand of Nakashima. Forehand from Kyrgios into the backhand of Nakashima. Again, to the backhand of Kyrgios in the net. 40-30. Let's play some tennis talk bingo. Good serve there. Nakashima with a drop shot from Kyrgios. That goes into the backhand of Nakashima, and Nakashima hits it in the net. All right. Two games all. Let me get the... get the bingo card working. At the end of this game, I'll show you the card so you guys know what's up. There's a bit of fault from Nakashima. 2-2. Second serve into the backhand of Keegs. Forehand from Nakashima to the forehand of Kyrgios to the backhand of Nakashima. Into the backhand of Kyrgios. Again to the slice of Nakashima. Forehand from Keegs. Again, cross-court of the forehand of Nakashima to the forehand of Kyrgios, who hits it in the net. 15 love.
Not too bad. I've never watched Nakashima live. How is his attitude on court?
Thank you for the donation, Diego. He's a very cool customer. Very cool customer. 30 love. No bullshit. None of that. I'm asking a question, getting no response. Well, I'm watching the match. 30 love. There's been a return from Keegs. That goes out. 40 love. 40 love. As Nakashima serves again. He says fault. Second serve. Serve out wide of the back of Kyrgios into the forehand of Nakashima. Forehand from Keegs on the stretch. Nakashima in the open court. Kyrgios can't get it. Nakashima, 3-2. 15 minutes. This game is flying. Okay, now let's go and I'll show you the bingo card for Kyrgios. Kyrgios bingo, because we've played this many times. Tennis Talk Bingo, Kyrgios Edition, you can see here. Basically, it's just like a normal bingo. If Kyrgios does one of these things, you tick it off. So, he has already done an underarm serve. So that's been crossed off, I'm printing it out. Also, Kyrgios already talking to the umpire, but he hasn't argued with the umpire yet. Talk to the crowd, swearing, 1 minute service game, which I think he's already done. Second serve, massive second serve. Shouting at the coach's box, trick shot, smash a racket. Or says that he's not playing. So that's it, code violation as well. So there is Kyrgios Bingo. I have the card. Here is the bingo card. Let me get my marker and we can get bingo underway. Already done an underarm serve. Go purple. Purple marker today, so you guys can see it on the screen. So Kyrgios Bingo, what has he done? He's already done an underarm serve. Now you're playing along at home, so make sure if he does anything that I might miss, make sure you do tell us so I can keep up to date with what is happening, just in case I missed one. So he's already done an underarm serve. That is Crossed off. Okay. Keegs with a good serve down tee and then a drop shot in the net. Now the trick shot has to go in. So it can't be, a trick shot that he, like a tweener that he hits out. It has to be in. All right, 15-all. Kyrgios with a big serve down the tee, 30-15. Another ace. To everyone up to date with the bingo, we know how to play the bingo. All right. Serve down the tee, the forehand of Nakashima, forehand from Keegs. Into the back end of Nakashima, volley from Kyrgios is too good. 40-15. This might be the 1 minute service game. This might be one. It's got to be a 1 minute service game already, right? Am I right? Serve down to the slice of Nakashima. Backhand now from Kyrgios. The backhand of Nakashima. Into the forehand of Keegs. Forehand now from Nakashima again. To the forehand of Kyrgios. Down the line is a winner. What a shot from Keegs!
This is going to be on Tennis TV. Right?
What a shot! Now, it's got to, they've got to confirm on the screen that it's a 1 minute game. We can't just kind of assume. Usually they show like the timer. And it says like, 59 seconds or something. All right. 17 minutes in this one. 3-3. Yeah, that was more than a minute. It needs to be like four aces. All right. Serve down to the back end of Kyrgios. We've got no break points yet. It's been a solid start from both guys on serve. He's got a backhand rally. Kyrgios again to the backhand. Nakashima into the backhand of Kyrgios. Again to the backhand of Nakashima. To the backhand of Keegs. To the backhand of Nakashima. There's been a backhand rally still. Going cross court. Nakashima, though, hits it wide. Love 15. Diminor, by the way, he is in a fourth set with Garen. And he's down a break. The demon. Under pressure. This is like when I used to listen to sport on the radio. Oh, there you go. Yeah, this is kind of an updated version of that. We've taken that concept and made it a little bit more modern. But hopefully you enjoyed. Should I get a stopwatch? Greg's, if you could, that'd be great. Don't stress yourself, though. Feel free to if you want, mate. Anyways, Nakashima, 15-all. Serves a fault. Second serve. Serve goes to the back of the Keegs. Sliced wide. Nice serve again from Nakashima. 30-15. Yeah, Garen coming back. Rabakina won the first set against Martic. That's a good good start for her. All right, 30-15. Nakashima with the serve. Down the tee, the forehand of Kyrgios. Back in now from Nakashima into the back of the Keegs, who hits it wide. 40-15. 40-15. All right, 40-15. As Nakashima serves to get back the lead. We have no breaks points yet. We're going to serve now and the return of the net from Kyrgios, and it's 4-3. Nakashima on this Independence Day. All right. So yeah, so if you're just joining us, we have bingo. With the bingo card here. We've only had the one so far. We've just crossed off the underarm serve. He hasn't done anything else yet. I don't know. Smashing a racket, unless he smashes against a chair. I don't know if that's going to happen today. I don't know if he can smash a racket today. The grass is pretty, it's pretty hard to break things on the grass. All right. How we doing? Does the racket have to break? Yeah, I think breaking a racket has to be break. All right, how we doing? Why isn't Martic match being played on TV? I don't know. Probably because it's on court number two. The underarm serve was a let. Okay, so do you want to count that? No, we can't count the underarm serve then. Is that what you're saying? Cam, what do you think about Federer's appearance at Wimbledon? Yeah, it was cool to see him. Everyone was freaking out. You reckon we have a five setter here? Yeah, I think this is going to go five. I think this is five. What do you guys reckon? You reckon five sets? No, no spitting. We don't want to encourage that behavior. It was a one-time thing from Kyrgios that he spit. So we don't want to... We're not going to add that onto the list. Just the funny stuff. You know, that's a little bit too intense. Just the, you know, just the circus stuff. Yeah, SJ, you keep coming in here and spreading that, mate. It's cool. Like, not everyone likes everyone. That's fine. You know, what's the... Pat Cash doesn't like Kyrgios. Okay, and what's your point? Do you have a... Do you have a follow-up sentence, or are you just going to keep saying that? Because I think you've said that 10 times. All right, dirty love. As we're back in return there from Nakashima to the back end of Keegs, and Keegs hits it out. 30-15. Four sets at most. Okay. 1 minute game coming up. He's got to win this game. Well, he's got to serve two aces now. Serve down to the forehand of Nakashima. That goes out. And it's 40-15. 40-15. And the first serve is a fault. Someone posted that anyone who thinks Goffin has a chance against Norrie knows nothing about tennis. I would say that person doesn't know about tennis. Yeah, I agree. Goffin can easily beat Norrie tomorrow. Kyrgios, by the way, is holding his shoulder. Oh, no. He's poking his shoulder, Keegs. Four games all, and he's hurt the cannon. And this is why I didn't think he could win Wimbledon, because we all see how exciting he can be in the first rounds, but when it gets to the later rounds, he is injury prone. So that's why I'm always worried about Kyrgios, you know, and I doubt his chances because of injuries. Remember, he retired from Wimbledon last year because of injury. As he puts the forehand wide. And it's 15 love. Serve goes to the forehand of Keegs, and that's in the net. 30 love. Nice serving from Nakashima. No BS today. This is all business. Nakashima's not playing into Kyrgios' antics, and Kyrgios hasn't even started the antics. So, I mean, I don't think Nakashima's gonna be bothered. 40 love, great ace out wide from Nakashima. 40 love. What do you love? Nakashima serves again. A fault. Second serve. As he double faults Nakashima, 40-15. All right, Nakashima trying to get back that... Trying to get that 5-4 lead. Force Kyrgios to serve to stay in it. Nakashima's been very solid to start. As he serves down to the back of Kyrgios. That goes out. Nakashima, 5-4. Five games of four, and Kyrgios still focusing on what's going on with his shoulder.
Answer my question! The question, jerk!
All right. Let's answer some questions. What do I think about Kyrgios' antics? It depends. Depends which ones they are. You know? I mean, at the end of the day, it's all entertainment, I guess. Yeah. I don't know. It depends on what they are. Yeah, this is a quick set. Very quick set. Dimonor going to go five? Maybe. I mean, he is struggling in that fourth set. I bet on Nakashima for fun. Yeah, no, Nakashima. I could have said it easily. Nakashima could have won this match. He's solid as a rock. And you notice already. Now, what happened yesterday? What happened the other day with what happened the other day with Tsitsipas? Now, Tsitsipas, we know even more now that Tsitsipas doesn't like what Kyrgios does. That stuff's not going to work against Nakashima if it is, in fact, gamesmanship by Kyrgios. It's not going to work because Nakashima, as we've seen so far, is very, very quiet. He's not going to be getting into it. He doesn't get emotional. Tsitsipas gets emotional at times. And I think, you know, Kyrgios is like, well, if I do any crazy circus stuff, Nakashima's not going to change. It's not going to affect Nakashima's game at all. Getting the crowd involved, Nakashima's going to be cool. Like, everything is going to keep Nakashima chill. Also, I think this crowd is more pro-Nakashima than they are Kyrgios, to be honest. Center court crowd's a little bit of a different level, you know? Anyways, Nakashima puts away the forehand, love 30. Let's get back to it. The crowd are definitely louder for Nakashima. Whereas court one was louder for Kyrgios. Keek serves to the forehand of Nakashima. Backing out from Kyrgios in the net. Wow, Kyrgios is giving this game away. Love 40, out of nothing. Keek serves. An ace. 15-40, saves one. He's out of nowhere. He serves now the forehand of Nakashima. Forehand from Kyrgios goes out. Kyrgios is distracted. Kyrgios is not thinking about this match. He's thinking about his shoulder. He's not thinking about this match. And that's why he lost that set. Nakashima, 6-4. Nick Kyrgios is not focused on him, on his game. He is focused on his shoulder. And Nick Kyrgios loses the set in the blink of an eye. All right, first set, Nakashima, 6 winners, 4 errors. Kyrgios, 13 winners, or 12 winners, 5 errors, including 6 aces. But he's got an injury. The shoulder is a problem. And Kyrgios looks flat. He looks flat. No energy, disinterested. He doesn't look like he wants to be there today. Or doesn't want to be there at the moment. Maybe that'll change. All right. There would be no reason for Kyrgios to feign an injury at 4-4. There must be pain. Yeah, yeah. I mean, Kyrgios never really pretends he's injured. I mean, if you've ever seen Kyrgios, lately, he doesn't play possum. He's done it in the past, but he hasn't done it lately. And I doubt that he'd be doing it today. I mean, that was pretty clear that last game was not the game of a healthy man. Should he retire? No. No. Do you think the right coach could settle Kyrgios down emotionally? No. I don't think Kyrgios would listen. If Dimonor plays Kyrgios and also like in this match, it's kind of like RBA vibe. Yeah, but Dimonor's a little bit more... I feel that Kyrgios, his belief, if he does play Dimonor, he believes he can beat Dimonor. I don't think Kyrgios has... I think he can't... He doesn't believe he can beat RBA. But I reckon he believes he can beat Dimonor. So there's a little difference there. The belief of Kyrgios is a lot different between those two players when he plays those two guys. All right. Nakashima serving first in this second set as he gets the 30 love. What did Keeks do to injure his shoulder? Probably just served a couple of big bombs and maybe just tweaked it. It happens. All right, Nakashima serves the forehand to Kyrgios. Great return from Keegs. Massive return. 30-15. Awful game. There are no interesting rallies, only serves and some strokes. Well, this is like serve. Yeah, it's a serving display. It's a serve bot match at this point. And Nakashima, 30-15. First serve's a fault. Second serve. Second serve to the backhand of Kyrgios. Backhand now from Nakashima to the forehand of Kyrgios, who hits a winner. 30 all.
I've played him twice, and like, I'm sorry.
30 all. All right. Couple of good forehand winners. Just kind of whipping them cross court. And down the line, getting the winners. As Nakashima serves. Down the tee, the slice of Kyrgios. Forehand from Nakashima. Into the forehand of Kyrgios, who shanks it. Nakashima with a volley. It's too good. Nakashima, too good. 40-30. Nakashima is just solid. The dude is just a rock. Mentally, physically, and his game is... seems to have an all-court game. He is just... very stoic. No emotion. Positive or negative. He is... And even when he wins a point, you know, a long point, he just walks off to the next one. He's almost like a classic 90s kind of... It's funny, you've got like Kyrgios, the modern guy, the modern player, whereas Nakashima is like a throwback to an era of no shouting, no celebration, just like get on with it. That's Nakashima. Win a point, move on. Win a point, next one. Always moving on. He's a robot. Well, you can go with that. You can say he's a robot, but... he's just kind of getting the job done. Reminds me of Sampras, yeah. This is like Sampras Agassi in terms of personalities. And Kyrgios is definitely unlike himself, and I think it's because he's hurting. His shoulder is sore and his serves are affected. As we get a backhand now from Kyrgios into the net. Oh, it goes over. Just goes over. 30 love. You know what's funny, though? Nakashima is the player that people... whenever they watch Kyrgios, people want players... everyone to be Nakashima. So, here he is. Is this... you want everyone to be like Nakashima? Everyone to be stoic and robotic and get on with it? I love that Nakashima is like that. But do you want everyone to be like Nakashima? Because that's what people are crying for in tennis. Like, everyone has to be like that guy. Very, like, just play a point, move on. Play a point, move on. No celebrations, no emotion, just like a Van Lendl, right? No bullshit, just get through it. Is that what you guys want, or do you want... like, I like this contrast in personalities, to be honest. We need Kyrgios. We need Nakashima. We need them all. As we're to serve. Out wide of the forehand, Nakashima. This is 30 all here. Kyrgios in big trouble, and now it's 30-40. Uh-oh. Kyrgios in the net. 30-40. First serve is a fault. Second serve. Into the forehand of Nakashima. Forehand from Kyrgios. Here's a winner. Living and dying. It's like Ostapenko. We're watching Ostapenko right now. Living and dying by the ground strokes. As he serves an ace down the tee. He's shaking his head, though. Yeah, he's... Kyrgios, his shoulder's done. His shoulder's done. If Kyrgios does win this match somehow, he won't be playing the next round. Quarterfinal? I don't think Keegs is going to be getting that far. If he does win this match. Return now from Nakashima. Forehand now from Kyrgios. The forehand Nakashima. Into the forehand of Keegs. Again to the forehand of Nakashima, who hits it in the net. And again, shake of the head from Kyrgios. He is not feeling it today. Hurting. I hope Kyrgios can finish this match. Always an excuse. Okay, do elaborate. What do you mean by always an excuse? What's an excuse? What do you mean? Elaborate on your statement. What do you mean? What's an excuse? Always an excuse. All right. 1-1. I was going to serve. Into the forehand of Kyrgios. Whoa, what a return. The forehand doesn't hurt. Just the serve, but that's the weapon. The serving. So if you've got a bad shoulder, lifting your hand above your head, that hurts. That seems to be the problem. Anything here is fine. So here is okay. Here, no good. Definitely struggling to hit with the serve. Hit the serve. He's got a forehand now from Nakashima to the back end of Keegs. Back end now Nakashima to the forehand of Kyrgios. He hits it wide. Another error. 15-all. As Nakashima, who's been very impressive. Even though, players get fooled by players that are hurting too. If someone looks like they have an injury, some players mentally go, oh, well, I'm going to beat you then. And then that's when they stop playing properly. Nakashima's not fazed. He's just focusing on his side of the court. Kyrgios is hurting. He doesn't care. He's going to play like he's not. As that goes in the net from Nakashima, 15-30. Nakashima's just, like someone said, all business. All business. No celebrating, no... Nothing. Just playing the next point. Win the next point. And he's got a solid all-round game as well, Nakashima. As he serves a fault. Second serve. Serve goes to the back end of Keegs. Back end now from Nakashima. Into the back end of Kyrgios. Again to the back end of Nakashima. Into the back end of Keegs. To the slice of Nakashima. Forehand now from Kyrgios again to the backhand of Nakashima. Into the forehand of Kyrgios. Nakashima in control here as we go forehand to forehand. Kyrgios down the line. Into the backhand again of Nakashima. And Kyrgios slices that in the net. 30-all. Nice hitting from Nakashima. Big points still. No break points against the Nakashima serve. Kyrgios still grabbing his arm. First serve is a fault. Second serve. It's a double fault. Nakashima, that's the first sign of some crazy play. Nakashima trying to hit a big second serve at 30-all. That is the first sign of strange behavior from Nakashima. As he serves. Another fault.
Can't buy a first serve.
All right. First break point against the Nakashima serve. Second serve. Out wide at the back end of Kyrgios. That goes wide from Keegs. He's going to challenge, but... That was a very quick out by both the linesman and the umpire. And that ball was wide by this much. All right, saved. Saved the break point. Back to deuce. Back to deuce. Nakashima serves. A fault. And he challenges.
That ball was on the line. Shot flew out.
He's going to challenge too. By the way, Dimonor is getting in a real sketchy situation. Alex Dimonor is already down a break in the fourth. And that was wide by Nakashima.
You cannot be serious.
Second serve. Second serve, Nakashima. Is another double fault. Wow. He's done that twice now. He's double folded with big second serves. Unnecessary big second serves. And he gives Kyrgios a chance here to get the break in the second. Servants, another fault.
Come by a first serve.
Second serve. Return now goes into the forehand of Nakashima. That's a good return from Keegs. Nakashima comes in. As everything freezes. And Kyrgios breaks. What? Kyrgios gets the break. Now I wonder how long it is going to be until he gets a trainer on court just to kind of give him something to something to deal with, you know? Oh, it's right now. Trainer's on court right now. What about perfect timing. As Kyrgios says, I can't lift my arm high like above here. It hurts. I mean, what can they do? They can massage it. They can give him some medication. That's it. They can loosen it up. That's about it. And he's saying, I can't even like go like hit forehands properly. There you go. Okay. Nakashima gives Kyrgios the lead for the first time today with a break. Okay, what do we have? Let's answer the question.
Answer my question! The question, jerk!
Garen and Diminor was a battle? Yeah, it wasn't supposed to be. Kyrgios is saying it's getting worse. The pain in the arm is getting worse. So let's put this on the screen. There you go. So he's getting some magic pills. Magic pills to hopefully well, numb the pain or do something. But he said it's getting worse. The shoulder is getting worse. Not looking for good for Demon. Well, yeah, he's. He looks like he's going to play a fifth, which should have won that in three sets. All right, Kyrgios. Back on court, serving with a 2-1 lead. But he's in pain. He's got a sore shoulder. And unfortunately, he's playing against a rock. You see, if he was playing against someone who was a little bit more mentally fragile, maybe Kyrgios could win the mind games, but Nakashima ain't going to get in the mind games. He's not going to be bothered by it. So Kyrgios can't do anything. He can't have a mental battle and try and distract Nakashima. Nakashima's too solid. So Kyrgios is going to have to get better or not looking good. As he serves a couple of aces. Bang, bang. 30 love. No, they're not allowed to do injections during the match, no. Not allowed to get injections during the match, I don't think. I think you can only get injections and anesthesia and, you know, numbing, you know, whatever, before the match and after. You can't get it during. That would be crazy. Players going off court to get jabs. Kyrgios, by the way, this is going to be a minute game if he can get this next point. 40 love, second serve. Out wide of the back end of Nakashima. Back in now Kyrgios to the forehand of Nakashima. Is into the forehand of Kyrgios. Back in now Nakashima again to the forehand of Kyrgios. Into the back end of Nakashima. Kyrgios with a volley. Nakashima with a pass. Keegs with a volley. Is too good. Kyrgios wins the game. And he consolidates the break, but he doesn't look like he's having fun. Numbing the shoulder wouldn't help anyway. Fair enough. Okay. 3-1 second set. As Diminor breaks back one of the breaks back against Garen. Now that was just over a minute, I think. It was like a minute three. As Nakashima serves an ace. So it wasn't a minute. It was about 45 seconds when he served his second serve, but it was a long rally, so. All right, 15 love. Serving to the forehand of Kyrgios. Backhand now from Nakashima. Into the backhand of Keegs. To the forehand of Nakashima. Forehand from Kyrgios again to the forehand of Nakashima. Who hits it in the backhand of Kyrgios. Half volley from Nakashima is too good. 30 love. And it looks like... looks like Rybakina is one game away from victory to get to her first quarterfinal at Wimbledon. She has the game to win Wimbledon, let's be honest. Rybakina is a Wimbledon... Should play well at Wimbledon based on her style. Anyways, 30 love. Backhand from Keegs into the slice of Nakashima. Again to the backhand of Kyrgios. Backhand now Nakashima sliced into the tweener of Keegs. That counts. Tick it off the list. As we had a slice there from Kyrgios. Now Nakashima comes in with the forehand. Kyrgios with the backhand. Pass! Nakashima hits it out. Get your bingo cards out. Tweener, trick shot. Let's cross it off the list. There it is. Trick shot confirmed. And he won the point, which is even more exciting. Okay. Now, Kyrgios hasn't, because he's not in the mood today, he hasn't done any of the usual things because he's hurting. He's too focused on his injury to bother about yelling and screaming and getting crazy. So, as Nakashima wins a point, 40-15. So, I don't know if we're actually going to get, like, Kyrgios getting angry or code violations. Because he's not really in that mood today. Serve. Out wide of the forehand of Keegs. Forehand out from Nakashima is a good shot down the line. Nakashima solid as a rock. He may be down a break, but you wouldn't know it. 3-2, Keegs. But Nakashima ain't going nowhere. Okay.
Answer my question! The question!
Yeah, we got the bingo. He's already done an underarm serve. And he's already done a trick shot. We've got a lot of other things to cover. But as of right now, I don't think he's going to do too many of the others. Because his attitude, he's not in that attitude right now. He's not angry enough. He's just like, I guess, you know, distracted. Will Kyrgios fight on or give up? Unfortunately, he's not known to fight through these kind of things. You know, the record shows that when he gets injured, doesn't usually win through injury. Oh, there we go. How about that? What do you guys reckon? You reckon it's a 50-50? I don't think so. I reckon Nakashima is still the big favorite here. Yeah, I forgot to have Kyrgios bingo for the City Pass match. I know we should have had that hindsight. Kyrgios won't go 5 sets with that shoulder. Yeah, exactly. Unless the shoulder gets better and he miraculously plays better. I don't think the shoulder... I mean, if the shoulder doesn't get better, it's not going to be 5 sets. Or it might be 5 sets if Nakashima gets nervous, but... I don't think Kyrgios is winning with a sore shoulder. We would have filled the bingo card already? Yeah. You got to remind me next time. I always forget that we got bingo. So Keegs outside his outdid his shoulder, which again is due to low intensity training and not being prepared. Partly... as that ball was on the corner, by the way, from Keegs. Great serve. And Kyrgios just like puts his hands in the air like... did I win that point? Yep, okay. 30 love. As he serves another ace. 40 love. But yeah, Megs, that's probably part of the reason. Maybe that's part of the reason. But I think the main reason is that he hasn't played enough tennis. You know? No, he hasn't played enough matches. You know, he's not match fit. You can train all the time in the world, but you've got to be match fit. And put yourself under the pressure of that intense match, you know, match play. And he hasn't done that over the season. As Kyrgios gets a game, another love game, and he's 4-2. So yeah, so look, I think people underestimate how much Kyrgios actually does train. You know, just because he doesn't show it on social media doesn't mean he's not doing it. Does he train more than, you know, Rafa Nadal? Probably not. But I'm not, you can't be, like, he doesn't just walk out on court and play. Like, he does, he's in the gym, he'd be in the gym. I mean, if he wasn't in the gym, he'd be fat. Like, look at him. He's an athlete. He's thin, he's, you know, the dude does his job. But also, he's injury prone, and also he doesn't play enough matches. And the lack of match play is what really, I think, is what causes these injuries. Because you can go train your arms and you know, and practice matches, but when you're really trying to power down serves and you haven't played that much, which I'm worried about next week when I go play tennis for the first time and I hurt my... I'm going to be so sore next week. You know, that's where you put your body under the stress of a real match, you know, over and over and over. That kid, you know, that Tsitsipas match was not easy, you know, mentally, physically. So that's why I think he's injured. Serving to the forehand of Kyrgios, that goes long on the return. 30 love. Nakashima just solid as a rock. Rabakina gets the win, by the way. She's into the quarterfinals. Anyone think Rabakina could lift this trophy? Maybe. Also, Dimonor's trying to avoid a fifth set. If Nakashima serves an ace. 40 love. Seems fine in this set. No, he's not. He's just getting a lot more free points. Nakashima's given him a lot of free points than the first set. Nakashima's dropped his level. There are too many beers. Yeah, he was lifting too many beers, so he must have done his shoulder lifting beers. As we had a forehand, a slice of Kyrgios. Good one, Joe. As Nakashima hits that in the net. And it's 40-15. And Nakashima, to stay in touch. It's not like a match play, okay. I mean, how many matches has he played in the last couple of weeks? Tell me in the chat. How many matches has he played in the last 3 months? There's a bit of serve now from Nakashima. Out wide of the back end of Keegs. Four now Nakashima. Into the slice. Four now Kyrgios. Four now from Nakashima is a winner again. And Nakashima is doing a great job of just hanging tough. Because like in the first set, Kyrgios could just play a terrible game in a minute and give the break straight back. By the way, Garen's going to a fifth against Dimonor. Oof. Uh-oh. Kyrgios is not behaving at all. I mean, he's not reacting at all. He's just kind of playing tennis and injured, I guess. How come this is 1 point ahead of the BBC live stream? Because BBC is behind by a minute. I mean, that's just because they're on delay. Because if someone says something rude, they can bleep it out. We're live as it comes. No delay. Kyrgios has got a bad shoulder. Kyrgios got a bad shoulder. Nakashima some sleeping pills so that he can be defaulted. What? What is that we talking about? Man, the chat's wild. I can't understand half of it. It's all over the place. We're having seven different conversations. What's going on? How does the Ukraine fit into this? For once, he is not running his mouth. yeah, so, and this has happened before. I've watched a lot of Kyrgios and, yeah, Randy, weird comments. When Kyrgios is injured, he doesn't do his usual thing, which is maybe a good thing. He actually just plays the game. Doesn't waste his energy. And right now, it's just Kyrgios' serve. That's all it is. Like, Kyrgios is just living off the serve at this point. Even though he's in pain, he's still just blasting serves because he's like, well, that's all I can do. Doesn't want to play long rallies. We had a backhand now from Kyrgios that goes wide. And he's just trying to hit winners off every shot because he doesn't want to play more. You know, doesn't want to test out that shoulder anymore. And also, like I mentioned at the start of this match, this crowd is not the same as the other crowd. The crowd in Set Court 1 was not the same. So, of course, they're not going to have the circus on center court. That wouldn't... The center court crowd are too posh for that. There's a bit of backhand that goes into the forehand of Keegs, and Keegs in the net, 30-all. Same thing happens at, like I said, at the Australian Open. If you play on Rod Laver Arena, you're not going to get the same crowd as you do when you play on Margaret Court. Margaret Court have a different price for the tickets, which means that, you know, people can get in there a little bit easier and spend more money on drinks. Center court crowd, it's very expensive. Whereas court one may be cheaper. Therefore, crowd. Kyrgios with a good serve down the tee. Bang. 40-30. And that's why when he played Nadal earlier this year, or whenever he played Nadal last year, whenever it was, on the center court at, you know, on Rod Laver Arena, it wasn't the same crowd because it's Rod Laver Arena. That's just the way it goes. Keegs looking to get the 5-3 lead. And stay in front with that break. And he does with a good serve. We're in the second set. 5-3. Kyrgios. I still think Nakashima is the favorite though. Keegs is playing... I mean, it's hard to say that he's playing better. He's just kind of gritting his teeth and hitting big serves, big ground strokes, and it's working for now. Nakashima played one bad game. That's why he's down a break. He double-faulted twice in that game, and that's why he lost the break. Yeah, Garin's up a break in the fifth. What is happening to Demon? Ugh. Oh, man. Demon or in his own head. All right, 15 love. Serve out wide at the back end of Kyrgios. Back end of Nakashima to the back end of Kyrgios. Again at the back end of Nakashima. Back end of backhand as Nakashima slices it. Keegs to the back end again. Into the back end of Nakashima. Back end now from Keegs down the line. Nakashima with a forehand. Into the forehand of Kyrgios. Into the back end of Nakashima who goes wide. Ooh, almost down the line. 15-all. Big point coming up here. Nakashima. I mean, he could get a free point or a free couple of games. Kyrgios is, you know, he was charitable in the first set. Kim, do you have money on the demon? No. Why? Why would I have money on the demon? All right, 15-all. Serve goes to the back end of Kyrgios. Four now. Doesn't need to be hit. Keegs hits it out. 30-15. Nakashima doing a good job at just asking Kyrgios the question. Can you serve it out with your bad shoulder? Serve is an ace from Nakashima. 40-15. To get the game and just, again, ask Kyrgios the question. How's that shoulder feeling? First serve's a fault. Second serve. Serve Serving to the forehand of Kyrgios, back forehand from Nakashima into the backhand of Keegs, who dumps it in the net. And Nakashima holds. 5-4, Kyrgios will serve for the second. Or try and serve for the second. All right, let's answer more questions.
That's my question! The question, jerk!
Also, Dimonor trying to break back in his match. Even match for Keegs leads the stats. Yeah, but that's because, I mean, half of his winners are aces. So he's hit 15 winners, 14 aces. So that's why the stats look so favorable because of his ace count. Is Korda injured? Yeah, Korda pulled out injured, I think, before the tournament. So, yeah. We're back in a big serve looking good for the title. Yeah, I mean, wasn't until we started losing the big names that she kind of popped up and was like, you know, she's legit. But the problem is her lack of experience. That's the only thing I'm worried about. Is she might be able to win the title, but does she believe she can? That's something that Rybakina, I think, struggles with. She can get to the big show, but can she win it all? You know, she's been in some big matches over the years and been the favorite, in fact. But can she take it to the... Like, mentally, can she get there? Because she's got the game to win Wimbledon. For sure. What do I think about Halep and Badosa? We're going to be watching that next. We're going to be watching that next. It's going to be a lot of fun, that one. Match of the day by far. All right, Kyrgios serving for the second to take this to a third at 1-1. As Keegs wins the first point, 15 love. So for the majority of the set, Kyrgios has been battling his shoulder. Well, actually for the whole match, he's been battling his shoulder. It seems to have numbed. He had some magic pills. He seems to have numbed the pain for now. As he serves out wide, a fault. Second serve. Is a wild second serve, double fault. And that was just showing straight away why Kyrgios doesn't want to play long rallies. He's like, yeah, I'm not playing a rally. I'm going to hit a second serve ace or a fault. I mean, I'm like, I ain't playing rallies. 15-all. Keeg serves. Another fault.
Can't buy a first serve.
Second serve. Into the slice of Nakashima. Back in there from Kyrgios. A drop shot. And it's too good. All right, 30-15. A little bit of touch from Keegs. 30-15. Kyrgios, 2 points away from leveling this up. I still think Nakashima, though, should be the favorite. I mean, anyway, serve goes in the forehand of Nakashima. Forehand from Kyrgios is another drop shot. Nakashima gets it, and Kyrgios hits it in the net. Nakashima too quick. He's too quick. 30-all. By the way, don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. We're almost at 500 likes as well. So thank you, everybody, for joining us. Happy 4th of July. Serve-wise, an ace from Kyrgios. That's what he needed. Set point, Keegs. God bless America. Is that the song? Land of the free. What's that song? What's the song that you guys always sing at the baseball? 40-30. Serve into the forehand of Nakashima. That's in the net. We've got one set, one. 1-1. 1-1 in this one. Why would Nakashima be the favorite? Because Kyrgios is still hurting. Kyrgios is still in pain. And Nakashima has played one bad game this whole match. And that's why he lost that set. He's played one bad game, Nakashima. And Kyrgios is hurting. So I again... Star Spangled, God Bless America, or Star Spangled Banner? Which one is called? Which one is it? Now let me try and. I don't want to get in trouble for playing this, but let's see what happens. Anyways, Kyrgios wins the second set. 18 winners from Keegs, 8 errors, 7 winners from Nakashima, 5. I couldn't get the right. You guys who were complaining about. No, just calm down. By the way, that was on the. Everything's backwards. Oh my God. People. Okay. All right. Moving on. It's not July 1st. What are you talking about? Nakashima wins the first game. One love. I would have put the original on, but we'd get in trouble. So I had to pick a one that was not going to get us in trouble. All right. By the way, I still don't think Kyrgios should be the favorite to win this match. I think Nakashima is in a better position, to be honest. I don't know about you guys. Who's going to win this set, though? That's the question. Who's going to win this set? Who is going to take this set? Because I reckon it's going to be... I reckon Nakashima is going to take it. As Kyrgios serves. Because I don't know, those pain pills aren't going to last forever. There's been a forehand rally. That goes into the forehand of Keegs, to the forehand of Nakashima. Again to the forehand of Kyrgios. Forehand of Nakashima down the line to the backhand of Keegs. Into the backhand of Nakashima, who hits it in the net. Forty love, good serving again from Keegs, but I think it's gonna wear off for sure. I think it's gonna wear off. As Nakashima comes in, no, Kyrgios puts away the volley. Nakashima. I think if he hangs around long enough, Nakashima's gonna get this set. The song was Star Spangled Banner. Okay, yeah. I was trying to find. A version that I knew wouldn't get us in trouble. So a version that was not like by Mariah Carey or something. But hey, I tried. I would love to play the original because I do. I think Americans have the. You guys have the best songs. Like your patriotism songs are so good. Like what's the it's called God Bless the USA, that song. The one that was like from the 80s. That song gets me excited for being American. And I'm not even American. And I get fired up from that song. No, I'm not going to play a Fergie song. No. I wanted to play one that was just a little bit. Not. That wouldn't get us in trouble. So we can at least play it. Anyways, 15 love. God Bless America is very popular. Okay. Yeah, that's the one that they play before like every sporting event. As that goes down the line and wide from Keegs, and it's 30 love Nakashima. It's God Bless America, isn't it? Is it? Oh. Carl Lewis. Is that the one? Maybe that's the one. That song's... Is that the one? Maybe. Anyways, 30 love. Serve to the back end of Keegs, and Keegs hits it long. 40 love. I'm going to have to play this song so I can hear if it's the right one. That's the worst thing about YouTube is that you can't play any tunes while we're live. There's been a serve volley from Nakashima, and that's too good. So what were you going to say? It was... No, that's not the song I was thinking about. No, it was God Bless the USA, not God Bless America. God Bless the USA was the one I'm thinking about. Yeah. You guys can't hear it, so it's all good. What's the chorus? Hang on, let me get to the chorus. You can't hear it, so it's okay. Yeah, it's not the the same guy sings both. No, you couldn't hear anything. It's all right. Anyways, you guys have, I love it. I love American patriotism. It's so cool. It's so much fun to like, I don't know, I get fired up for him. I don't know about you guys. And I ain't even from, I'm Australian. Just couldn't tell. God Bless the USA. That's the song I was thinking about, yeah. Anyways, happy 4th of July to everybody out there. Hopefully you've had at least 10 beers by now. It's 10 o'clock. You guys should be drunk by now. You Aussie fellas got koalas on the streets. Cool. That's super stereotypical, but okay. Fair enough. Do you like America? Yeah. Americans are sick. You guys are... I love Americans. I've been there 3 times. I've had a great time every time. Can we secretly American? No. No. I love Americans. You guys are awesome. You're so friendly to us. To Aussies. When we're there. Because I think we're like aliens. When we come over there, people are just like, why do you sound like that? It's like, oh, because I'm from Australia. And we're like from another planet. It's just so much fun. And the thing about America is, like, I grew up watching American TV, like, American shows, right? Probably, it's probably the same for everyone who's not from America. And then when you go there, you feel like you're on a television show because everyone's speaking the language of the TV. Or sounds like the people on the TV. So it's like a whole nother, like, that's what I got the vibe. And then when I went to New York, it felt like I was in a movie. Like, I just thought it was sick. And then when I went to the UK, I felt like I was in Mary Poppins. Anyways, 40 love, and a lovely fine from Keeks, 2-2. But, when you grow up watching American, like, television shows, like Seinfeld and, you know, Friends and all that other stuff, and then you go there and, like, everyone sounds like that, you're like, well, it's crazy. Because I'm used to hearing people sound like me. Then when you go over there and no one sounds like you, you're like, whoa, this is so creepy and cool. And you're the one who sounds weird. Like, that's what was weird for me. All right, 2-2. Anyways, that's why I'm a massive fan. I love it. I love going. And I've had a great time every time I've been to America. So happy 4th of July. And that goes wide from Keegs. You sound like Thor. Thank you. Isabella, appreciate it. 15 love. Nakashima, he has the advantage of serving first in this set. By the way, it looks like Dimino's coming back. Let's go. Also, Kubler against Fritz. Aussie versus American battle going on there as well. We'll keep an eye on that. Today is an unofficial Australia Day. With all the Aussies playing. As Nakashima double falls. 15-all. Serve out wide of the forehand of Keegs. Forehand out from Nakashima is sliced into the forehand of Kyrgios. Again, at the back of Nakashima. Drop shot from Keegs is in the net. In the net. 30-15. Nakashima trying to get the lead again. Serve into the forehand of Kyrgios. Backhand from Nakashima to the backhand of Keegs. Into the forehand of Nakashima. Again at the backhand of Kyrgios, who dumps it in the net. And again, rubbing his shoulder, Keegs trying to loosen it up. But this set is a huge, huge deal for Kyrgios, I feel. If Kyrgios doesn't win this set, he goes down a set, 2 sets to 1, and maybe a break. He might call it quits. I hope I'm wrong, but... Return now from Keegs is sliced into the backhand of Nakashima. Backhand now from Kyrgios. Again at the backhand slice of Nakashima. Into the backhand of Keegs, who hits it in the net. 3-2. Nakashima stays in front. And I feel like it's only a matter of time before he gets that chance to break. All right.
Answer my question! The question, jerk!
Has Kyrgios ever come back from two sets down? He won't have to, so that, I mean, maybe, but he won't have to today. Just 2-1 down, which he has done before. He'll definitely retire if he loses this set. Yeah, I got a feel, like, I wouldn't say definitely, but it's very likely, I think, if he does drop this set. When's Australian Independence Day? Good joke. All right, so Kyrgios is going to get a physio coming out again, so let's see what happens. All right, do we have any questions? Why is this on center court? Well, what match should have been? I mean, in hindsight, right? Dimonor versus Garin should have been, but because Kyrgios is an entertainer and everyone knows his name. Did you ever throw a racket in a game? I did. But I learned a very valuable lesson. So I threw a racket. Last time I threw a racket was when I was like 12. And I broke my racket. Or bent my racket out of shape. And my parents said, that's your racket. You're going to have to play with that. Never threw a racket again. So tough lesson to learn, but also valuable. So that last time I threw a racket was like when I was 12. And I've never done it since because it's just not worth it. It's not worth throwing rackets, breaking rackets. It's expensive. It's doesn't help you. It doesn't help you at all. I mean, it just makes, in fact, you know, it doesn't help you. It shows your opponent how you're feeling as well. It gives away your emotional state. So lose.
Goat. Greatest of all time. Spelled goat.
Hey, thank you, Jack, for the 20. Happy 4th of July, mate. Hopefully you're having a good one in Vegas. Hopefully it's not too hectic over there, mate. Hopefully you're having a good one. How's the weather treating you in Vegas? All right. Official medical time out here for Keegs. Trying to loosen up that shoulder. Did I ever experience a bagel? Yeah, so I have a funny story about that. I've been bageled. I think everyone in tennis has been bageled, right? I was bageled in a three-set match in the first set, and I came back to win. So that was my best bagel story, because I can't remember the other ones. If I lose 6-love, I'm not going to remember it. But I remember that one, because I came back and I won. But yeah, I've been bageled. Everyone's been bageled in tennis. And they say they haven't, they're lying. Everyone gets bageled in tennis. Even the GOATs. Look at that. They've been bageled. I think Djokovic is the only one who's avoided bagels for the most part, but everyone gets bageled in tennis. It's a part of tennis. You got to eat a bagel every now and again just to put yourself, you know, humble yourself, you know. I've also double bageled. That was fun. I remember that match. We were in a big, I think it was a quarterfinal matchup, and it was our team against this other team, and we'd beaten them earlier in the year, and I came out. I was the number one seed. I was the number one player, and I beat their number one player 6-love, 6-love. So I was pretty happy about that. I felt bad for the guy because he's actually a really nice guy, you know. And at the end of the match, he's like, you couldn't give me one game, man. And I was like, sorry. He was a nice dude as well, so I kind of felt bad, but. I've never been bageled. Fair enough. It's actually a cool morning in Vegas. Oh, okay. Interesting. Djokovic bageled both Nadal and Federer. Yeah, look, but Nadal also bageled Djokovic, remember? Oh, and Rublev. Yeah. So, yeah, everyone gets bageled at some point in tennis. It's a good lesson to learn, I think. Getting bageled is a good, you know, it's good for the soul. You know, to take an L every now and again, just so you can regroup. You learn more from a loss than a win, right? So if you will learn way more from getting bageled than you will from bageling, trust me. If I beat someone 6-love, it's like, okay, so I played well. But if I got bageled, I'd be like, okay, so what went wrong? What do I have to work on, you know? What do I need to fix so I never have to do that, feel that again? You know, you always get learn more from a loss than a win. And a bagel is no exception.
Not too bad.
My sickest one. I was down first set love 5, then I came back and won 7-5. And the second set I won 6-love.
Holy cow, you won 13 games in a row. That's crazy. Diego, that is a beastly comeback, mate. I think everyone has one of those stories too, where you've come back from the dead. I remember one match where I was up 5-love in a second set. I won the first in a tiebreak, and I was up 5-love in the second, and I let the guy get back to 5-all. And I tell you what, I was playing so nervous at 5-all, and I won 7-5, but my God, that was the worst feeling. When you're up 5-love, and you give away the 5-love lead, and you get to 5-all, you're like, holy crap, that's a battle. But when you're down 5-love and you come back, I mean, hell, Diego on fire, mate. All right, let's get back to this. Kyrgios gets a shoulder rub. And let's see if it makes any difference. 30-love. I'm sure we all have those stories if you're a competitive tennis player. Probably all got those stories of triumph and misery. We all have them. I'm sure I'll have some stories to tell when I go back to tennis next week. I'm sure next week I'll lose. I'm pretty much going with the attitude that my first round match next week, I'll lose because I haven't played for years. And then anything less than a loss is a win for me. Anyways, backhand to backhand rally as that goes into the forehand of Kyrgios. And slice there from Nakashima goes down the line. Kyrgios with a forehand, but he hits it wide. Just let it bounce. He should hit a volley, or at least tried to go for that volley. 30-15. Kyrgios has had a bad shoulder all day. And it's affecting his serve the most. Even though his serve is still pretty damn good with a sore shoulder. Also, Dimonor, who was up 2-love, is now in a 5th set against Garin. We'll keep an eye on that because the winner of that match plays the winner of this match. So, Dimonor trying to beat Garin in that epic. Serve into the forehand of Nakashima. Forehand from Kyrgios. The backhand of Nakashima. Into the backhand of Kyrgios. That's down the line to the slice of Nakashima. Forehand from Keegs. Again, is long. 30-all. This might be the game. This might be the game. 30-all. Kyrgios is not been in trouble since the end of the first. As he serves a let on the first serve. Also, we're almost at 98.2K, so thank you everybody for showing the love. Appreciate it. And happy 4th of July to all the Americans out there. As Kyrgios serves a big serve, and it's 40-30. That's what he needed. That's what he needed. Serve out wide to the slice of Nakashima. 4 now from Kyrgios. Again to the back end of Nakashima. And Nakashima hits it long. 3-all in this crucial 4th set. All right. Serve out wide as a fault. Second serve. Dimonor's up 5-4, by the way. And Fritz are up 3-love. As Kyrgios hits that return long, and he says he can't do anything involving that twisting of the shoulder. There must be a... Hopefully it's not a structural problem. It's probably just muscular, as that goes in the net from Kyrgios. Good serve. 30-love. Keegs. Just feel like this is going to go the way of the first set. The way Nakashima played, he just solid, held serve, and then eventually got that opportunity. Dimonor's 3 points away from the victory. Keep an eye on the demon as Nakashima serves into the back end of Kyrgios, and Kyrgios hits it in the net. 40-love. And Nakashima has not... He has just been like this. Like, he has not changed his emotions, his game. It's just been a rock. He has been solid. Kyrgios has obviously gone up and down because that's his Kyrgios, but Nakashima has just been a workhorse. Just come like, head down, butt up, working his butt off to win games, just getting through them and waiting for Kyrgios to inevitably explode. All right, 4-3. Nakashima in the start, in the lead. All right, questions.
Answer my question! The question, jerk!
I was wondering what the Brits think of 4th of July. They must think we're a bunch of rebels. Isn't 4th of July celebrating beating the Brits? I remember when I was in Vegas for 4th of July, and everyone, if you were British, you would get so much shit from the people. Maybe it was just because I was in Vegas, people are crazy, but it was like a celebration against the British people. Like, it was like 4th of July was like, yeah, we're free. And then it's like, is that guy British? Get him. And it was like, we're going to, like, they just made it hell for the British because that was like, there was the day that they lost to the, like, to the Americans. So, I just remember like the Americans were just given anyone who had an English accent hell because it was like, we kicked your ass in the war. We beat you. And it was like they played a game back in the day and, you know, their team won. It was hilarious. And I'm like, I'm from Australia. I don't know what's going on. I'm an Aussie. We're just hanging out down at the bottom of the earth. But is it like that around the world or is it not really? Do Americans care? I know the British don't care, but do the Americans like take it as like a, yeah, we kicked their ass. That's what it sounded like when I was there. But again, maybe I was hanging out with like drunk frat boys or something. Anyways, Kyrgios serves an ace out wide, but it's 30-love. As we get a serve now, the back end of Nakashima. Nakashima hits it wide. 40-love. Dimonor's got match point, by the way. Dimonor's got match point. Come on, Demon. And he gave it away. All right, 40-love. First serve is a fault. Second serve. Into the forehand of Nakashima, forehand of Kyrgios, the forehand of Nakashima, again to the forehand of Keegs, he puts it wide. 40-15. Kyrgios serves an ace. 4-all, Kyrgios is gritting his teeth and staying in touch. I just feel like a tiebreak is what we need. I feel like a tiebreak is only fair. Maybe it's just me. Does anyone else want a tiebreak? the end of this, to finish off this important third set. First serve is an ace from Nakashima. As he serves a fault, second serve. Good serve out wide to the backhand of Keegs. Backhand now Nakashima. Forehand now from Kyrgios down the line to the backhand of Nakashima. Backhand now from Kyrgios again to the backhand of Nakashima to the backhand of Kyrgios, who hits it into the forehand of Nakashima. Slice from Kyrgios to the forehand again of Nakashima into the backhand of Kyrgios, who hits it wide. Ooh, just goes wide from Kyrgios. He's going to challenge, but it was wide. And the ball was called wide. And it was wide. 30-love. 30-love. Nakashima serves again. Into the forehand of Kyrgios. That goes in. Well, there's a medical timeout going on in the Dimonor match. Dimonor's got a medical timeout going on. Let me have a look at what's going on there too, because that's at deuce. So Dimonor's got a medical timeout at deuce, which is never a good sign. The demon's in trouble. He's having a medical timeout at deuce. So something bad happened. Something bad must have happened. Oh, did he hurt his finger? Oh, okay. He must have slipped over and scratched his finger up. So I think it's a blood rule. Anyway, it's 40 love Nakashima. He serves out wide to the slice of Kyrgios. Backhand slice from Nakashima is long. Yeah, so Kyrgios, he's getting his fingers taped up. So I think he must have slipped and scraped his hand on the ground or something. He fell over and cut his hand. Okay, that's all right then. That's okay. Woo. Thought it was something more serious. 40-15. There's a bit of return from Kyrgios in the forehand of Nakashima. Backing out from Keegs to the slice of Nakashima, who puts it wide. Nakashima with a couple of errors, and it's 40-30. Got to be careful. All right, so the demon just had a bit of a trip, and he's all right. All right, 40-30. Still Nakashima to get that lead again as Garen hits a lovely shot. Keep an eye on that one for a second. 40-30. Nakashima. Serves a fault. Second serve. Serving to the back of Kyrgios. Good return. Nakashima gets it. Point out from Kyrgios with a drop shot. In the net. Nakashima stays in front. But he's doing it the hard way. He's doing it the hard way. All right. Nakashima stays in front in this crucial third set.
Answer my question! The question, jerk!
All right. Again, don't forget to subscribe. Thank you, everyone who has subscribed throughout the week. And we're just getting serious now. Now things are getting serious. You know, the fun and games are in the first week when we get upsets and all the random stuff. But in the second week is when we get a bit more serious. So we still have fun and make jokes and stuff, but we do get a little bit more. We focus on the serious stuff. No circus in the second week. You know, we don't expect the circus. Circus stops usually after the first week. Five all, by the way. Garen survived. Yeah, the business end of the tournament, exactly. Very impressed by Nakashima, yeah. Kyrgios always blames his shoulder on his bad shots. Yeah, he's probably got a sore shoulder. That's why. Maybe he's got a sore shoulder, so he's blaming it for his bad shots. Just a theory. Thoughts on team playing a challenger tomorrow? That's cool. Good on him. I think that's good. That takes a lot of guts to, you know, go from Grand Slam champion to challenger. to gain form. I mean, teams, no ego in team for sure. Yeah, Kyrgios, every change of ends, he's getting a massage. Now, Kyrgios cannot get another medical timeout unless it's a new injury. The only time you're allowed a medical timeout is if you get another injury for another for a different reason. So Kyrgios can get massaged after every change of ends because that's just, you're allowed that. But you're not allowed to have another medical timeout unless you have a new injury. As Kyrgios serves a big serve down the tee, 15 love. Garen, by the way, love 30. Oof. Serve from Keegs to the slice of Nakashima. Backing out from Kyrgios down the line is wide. 15 all. Now, this is what happened in the first set. One of these games. Where Nakashima was just cruising and so was Kyrgios. And then, all of a sudden, Keegs got broken. And the set was over. Serve down to the slice of Nakashima. Back in our Kyrgios. The forehand Nakashima is a winner. 15-30. 15-30. Lovely shot from Nakashima. Kyrgios gave up on that shot too early. He should have kept running. As the first serves a let from Keegs. Serve down to see the forehand of Nakashima's in the net. Good serve from Keegs. 30 all. Big point coming up here. Nakashima doing it for the 4th of July. Taylor Fritz, by the way, kicking ass, which I thought would happen. Serve out wide to the forehand Nakashima. That goes out on the return. And Kyrgios stays in front, 40-30 to level up at 5-5. Dimonor's down break point, by the way, against Garen. He's got Garen on the stretch. Garen in the net. Oh, Dimonor survives. Bloody hell, Demon. Anyways, 40-30, Kyrgios to the back end of Nakashima. Forehand from Kyrgios into the slice of Nakashima. To the forehand of Kyrgios. Again down the line, Nakashima can't get, or gets it. As Kyrgios puts the forehand down, up goes the lob. Kyrgios with a smash. Puts it away. And Keegs survives. 5-0 in the third. A must win, you would expect, for Kyrgios. 5-0 in the fifth. Can Kyrgios sneak out this set? If Kyrgios wins this set, I still think Nakashima can win. But if Nick loses this set, Nakashima is gonna win. I think in four. If they play the whole match. Return now goes to the forehand Nakashima. Backing out from Kyrgios, sliced into the forehand of Nakashima. Again the backhand of Kyrgios. To the backhand slice again from Nakashima. Kyrgios with a slice. Again to the slice of Nakashima. Who hits it in the net? Love 15. Love 15. No breaks in this third set. As Dimonor looks to get the lead again against Garen. And he does. He does. Alex Dimonor is going to play a tie break or win the match. As Nakashima hits an ace. Bang. Nakashima with the ace. Also, I'm curious because I'm seeing a lot of comments about Nick Kyrgios and his injury. Let me know in the chat, do you believe that he's faking or if it's a legit injury? Just say legit or fake. Because I'm curious because I see some people saying that Kyrgios is not really injured. Which I think is, I think he is injured. But you tell me in the chat, is it fake or is it legit injury for Kyrgios? 30-15. I'm going with legit. As that goes into the forehand of Keegs, forehand from Nakashima to the backhand of Keegs. Into the backhand of Nakashima. Forehand from Kyrgios is too good. All right, 30 all. All right, everyone says legit. All right, we're all on the same page then. Okay, 30 all. Things are getting serious now. Yeah, everyone says legit. Okay, that's cool. Maybe it's just a random few. But it felt like there was a lot of people being like, this is not real. Kyrgios acting again. And I'm like, really? I mean, it looks pretty sore to me. Return arrow. Keegs goes into the front of Nakashima. Back in now from Kyrgios is wide. Nakashima survives. 40-30. Okay, Nakashima. 40-30 to get to 6-5 and play a tiebreak or win the set. Serving to the forehand of Kyrgios. Forehand out from Nakashima. Into the open court. Keegs with a slice. Nakashima with a volley is going to be too good. Nakashima gets a 6-5. And the first sign of a little bit of emotion from Nakashima. Just a little bit of a fist bump. Huge game. Nakashima. All right. Come on. We need a tiebreak, surely. That's the only way we can get this sorted. Tiebreak time. Come on. Tiebreak for sure. All right. Garen 15 all, by the way. He's trying to get to a tiebreak as well to finish their match. Legit isn't a French word, it's English. Yeah, legit means legitimate. It's not a French word. It's just an abbreviation of a longer word that I can't be bothered saying. Legit means legitimate, which means real. Ranking for Nakashima, is he good on grass? Well, I think he's showing that he's good on grass by this tournament. He beat Chapo, who made the semis last year. So I think that's, even though Chapo's not the same guy he was, you know, last year, he's still Shapovalov. But his ranking, unfortunately, won't get higher because of today, which is a shame. But he is a very decent player. If you didn't know, now you do. Mentally very strong. I think that's his, you know, that's... He might not be flashy. He might not be like, you know, exciting. You know, big hitting, big serving, you know, classic American. But he's definitely mentally very strong and very reliable. I think that's what Nakashima is. He's reliable. You know, you've got your Fritz, you know, Tiafo. Those guys... You know, those guys have their moments. They're very exciting. Nakashima is just a workhorse. You know, he's not going to try and, you know, hit the winner of the tournament. He's just going to hit routines.
Shut your fuck up, okay?
And then you hit left and you don't say sorry. You think you're a new kid?
I told you to stop and you kept doing like this to the team.
It's a bullshit Russian. You think this is normal?
You have gained a lot of Polish tennis fans this year. I would beg that you and your brother design a shirt celebrate Siga's 37-match win streak in addition to the 6 tournaments she won.
Thank you, Rowdy, for the 10. 40, love. As Kira serves the backhand of Nakashima, backhand from Keegs, into the forehand of Nakashima, who goes out. We're going to a tiebreak. We're going to a tiebreak, and we're going to play this song because we can.
And now it's time for the tiebreak.
All right. Who's winning this tiebreak? And Rowdy, we'll get to your comment in a second, mate. We'll talk about it after this a little bit. Thank you for the 10. We'll get to that in a second. We already have Swiatek merch and no one buys it, so that's the problem. Here we go. All right. Tiebreak. Tell me who's going to win this score. Who's going to win and what's the score going to be? You tell me. You tell me. A lot of people going Keegs. Kyrgios, Kyrgios, Kyrgios. All right. I'm gonna go with Kyrgios for the sake of the match. I think if Kyrgios wins this set, we could get an epic five-setter. And if Kyrgios, if Nakashima wins, this could be over pretty quick. So, all right. Seems like a lot of you guys are going with Kyrgios. A few are going with Nakashima. Okay. All right. Let's see what happens. Also, Demonor and Garen are in a tiebreak too. That's for 10 points. This is a 7-point tiebreak. One-zero Nakashima. On serve. As Kyrgios serves out wide to the backhand of Nakashima. Forehand from Kyrgios to the backhand of Nakashima. Into the backhand of Keegs. Backhand to backhand is Kyrgios again to the forehand of Nakashima. Into the backhand of Kyrgios. To the forehand of Nakashima. Forehand from Kyrgios again to the backhand of Nakashima. Into the backhand of Kyrgios. One of the longest rallies of the match. As we get a backhand to backhand rally. Kyrgios now slicing that one from Nakashima into the backhand of Keegs. Into the backhand of Nakashima. Goes wide. Oh, he went for it. 1-1. He went after it. 1-1. Very fun matchup, this one. It's been a very close battle. Nakashima has just been an absolute rock throughout this whole match. Kyrgios hasn't been his crazy self, but that's because he hasn't been focusing on, he's been focusing on this sore bad shoulder that he's got. Serves an ace though, grits his teeth, smacks an ace down the tee, 2-1, bang. All right, 2-1, Keegs. Nakashima to serve. I feel like it's going to be one or two, like it's going to be a bad serving point or something that's going to change this tiebreak. The person who doesn't get the serve in is probably going to be the one who loses. That's how I'm feeling right now. Thank you, Snowdrifter. Appreciate it. Serve out wide. Double fault! 3-1, Kyrgios. Nakashima giving away the free point. Almost on cue. Lovely stuff. I mean, not great stuff from Nakashima. The double faults hurt him in the second set. That's why he got broken. Goes into the forehand now, Kyrgios, and that goes long, Keegs. All right, 3-2 Kyrgios with the mini break. But remember, the game that he lost Nakashima to get broken in the second was double faults. So the double faults have come to hurt him, and he's already at 6. So go figure. Again, don't forget to subscribe. We're almost at 1,000 likes. That is insane for this kind of a match. So thank you so much for that. Okay. Serve. Out wide from Keegs and ace. 4-2. They change ends. They change ends. Can Kyrgios serve his way to a lead? Jason just compared Nick Kyrgios' effort today like the flu game by MJ. Oh, man. Jason, you are, mate, that is exactly what I was thinking. This is so inspirational. It's exactly like that. I mean, it's one and the same, you know. We're going to remember this day. We're going to remember MJ's flu game, Nick Kyrgios' shoulder game. This is going to go down in the history of the sport. I know Jason was joking too, so that's funny. Yeah. Too funny. Anyways, 4-2 Kyrgios. So it's a fault. Second serve. Second serve. Into the back end of Nakashima, and that's in the net. Good second serve. 5-2 Keegs. Kyrgios. The flu game is food poisoning. Yeah, according to the documentary. They're going to make a last dance, Kyrgios edition, after this match. 5-2. I wonder if Kyrgios and Tsitsipas will be featured in the Netflix documentary. I wonder if they're going to be featured. Oh, Kyrgios with a winner down the line!
This is going to be on tennis TV.
6-2 Kyrgios! He takes this tiebreak over. All right, Nick Kyrgios not messing about. He may be hurting, but he's got four set points. Serve out wide of the forehand of Kyrgios. That's a great return. Nakashima can't get it. Nick Kyrgios has a 2-set-to-1 lead. What a comeback. Or what a fight, I should say, from Nick Kyrgios. Man, he doesn't look... I mean, he wasn't very excited by winning that tiebreak, but I guess he's busy focusing elsewhere. All right. Nick Kyrgios taking a 2-set-to-1 lead. All right, 20 winners from Kyrgios, 10 aces in that set. Eight unforced errors, 10 winners from Nakashima, and 6 errors, and no break points for either guy. I mean, that was a great serving display by both. And the tiebreak, the biggest server won the tiebreak. And the better server, because Nakashima double-folded. Remember that. Okay. Okay. By the way, Diminor and Garin are 3-3 in their set. Also, we are so close. We are so close to 98.2K. So thank you so much, everybody, for who subscribed today. If you're new in the chat, say hello. Love to talk to the new people. Now, Rowdy, you're saying, should we make an Iga Świątek 37 shirt? Look, we can, but I don't know. I don't really want to just, like, keep... let me know in the chat. Would you buy an Iga Świątek 37 shirt? Because I know we've got a lot of Polish fans, which is great. But we've also got the Iga number 1 shirt, and no one... Like, that doesn't... We've got a couple of people who have bought that, but it's not... I don't know, it doesn't really give me much hope in the fact that you guys actually want that stuff. I don't want to make merch for like 2 people. I want to make merch if everybody wants it, you know? Not just for like, you know, the 3 people in the chat who are like, hey, make a shirt, and I do, and then those people don't even buy it. I want to make shirts for people that, I want to make good quality stuff for all of you guys. I mean, it's a great achievement. You know, it's nothing to be, nothing, definitely something we could celebrate, but I don't know if we celebrate it with merch. Also, I don't want to sell you, I don't want to make merch for everything. You know what I mean? I don't want to be like, hey guys, here's another piece of merch you have to buy. Like, I mean, I don't want to, unless there's demand for it, I don't really want to sell shit to you guys all the time. I just want to chill. I just want to celebrate it as a channel rather than selling a shirt to you. You know what I mean? Yeah, I feel like Djokovic 21 or Nadal 24 is like big time. A 37 match win streak is very, it's good to celebrate, but...
If Noel doesn't stop Rafa, is calendar slammer locked?
No, not a lock, because I think Medvedev would be the favorite at the US Open, but I don't think it's a lock, but it's definitely achievable. Thanks for that, Milos. We have a Barty shirt already in the merch store. But yeah, Rowdy, look, it's a good idea, Rowdy, but I don't think people, I mean, I'm not sure if that many people want it. And I really don't want to just, I don't know. We've kind of taken a break for the merch, unless it's like serious, like massive milestones, like 23 slams. Oh, I dropped my pen. Because let's be honest, you didn't come here to buy a shirt, you came here to watch the tennis. All right, Kyrgios serving first. But hey, Rowdy, I'll think about it. It's a good suggestion. But again, I'm not really into selling. I don't want to sell you guys. I don't know. There's lots of merch. Go buy the merch if you want. You don't have to do anything, though. All right, 15:30. Nakashima, chance to get a break point for the first time since the second set. It's been a while. There's been a forehand rally that goes into the forehand of Nakashima, and Nakashima hits it in the net. 30 all. By the way, 5-5 between Demon and Garen. Whoa, that match is getting sketchy. By the way, Fritz won the first set against Kubler. So there you go, Taylor Fritz. All right, 30-30, big point to start off this fourth set. I subbed yesterday, I had to come back and watch and listen again. Oh, thank you, Ordered Steps, appreciate it. Welcome back. Welcome back to everybody who's joined us for the first time this week. There's a bit of drop shot there from Kyrgios to the slice of Nakashima. Volley from Kyrgios. Nakashima can't get it. 40-30. 40-30. As Keegs looks to get the first game of this fourth set. Seven-5, by the way, Garen. He's 3 points away from victory against Demonor. Man, that would be a crushing blow for Demonor. Being up 2 sets to love, match points to lose. Oof. Second serve is a double fault, but we're going to get a challenge from Keegs.
That ball was on the line. Shock flew up.
Double fault from Kyrgios. And that was out. And Kyrgios only has 1 challenge remaining, and we're in the first game of the freaking set. What the hell? All right. Slice from Nakashima as we get a backhand to backhand rally. Backhand now Nakashima again. The backhand of Kyrgios. We get a forehand from Keegs to the forehand Nakashima. Slice from Kyrgios is a forehand. Into the forehand of Nakashima, again to the slice forehand of Kyrgios. Backhand now Nakashima. Open court is in the net. Nakashima played such a good point as well. And he's a bit of a shake of the head from Nakashima. You don't see that. You don't see him showing much emotion. Also, it looks like Kubler has a medical timeout against Fritz. All the Aussies are having medical timeouts today. What the hell's wrong with us? What is wrong with us? By the way, Garen is 2 points away from victory. As Dimino comes in with a volley, and Garen gets the point. Oh, no. Garen's got 4 match points. Oh. As Kyrgios serves an ace. And it's 1-1 Keegs in the fourth. Now, can somebody tell me in the chat about what Pat Cash said about Nick Kyrgios? Because I'm trying to find quotes or something. Because apparently he was saying that he was rubbish for the game or something. What? Does anyone know the exact quotes, or does anyone have anything to so I can read? Because I'm trying to find something, but I can't find any any quotes. He said he's a disgrace. Okay, but can you send me that rather than you telling me? Because I feel like you're telling me that you think he's a disgrace, and I want confirmation. Not that I don't believe you, but I just don't believe you. So send it to me on Twitter so I can read it for myself. Quote him. I don't want to paraphrase Pat Cash. By the way, Garen, I think, just won. Demonor, that hurts. That's a bad beat for Demon. Bad beat for the Demon. Man. Great win for Garen. Who thought Garen could play on grass? He made the fourth round last year and he's made the quarters this year. Christian Garen will play the winner of this match. Christian Garen, Nick Kyrgios, Brandon Nakashima is playing a semi-final. One of them are in a semi-final. One of those guys is playing the semis. And I think, to be honest, if you want Nick Kyrgios in the semifinals, the fact he has to go through Garen is probably the best thing, because if he played against Dimonor, he probably would have been happy, content with losing. I don't think Kyrgios wants to lose to Garen. I think he'd be more content with Dimonor because it's like, oh, you're my friend. We'll see what happens, but Keeks has to win this match first. As that goes in the net, 15 all. Yeah, that's a bad beat for the Demon. Bad beat for sure. And I think Garen's proven that he's not just a clay courter. So, you know, if you thought he was just like this clay court guy, he's more than that. Garen's legit. All right, 15-all. Serve goes down the back end of Kyrgios, and that's in the net from Keegs. 30-15. Yeah, I'm not on Discord at the moment, Greg, so if you could send me it on Twitter, that'd be so much easier. I'm not on, I don't have my Discord open because it breaks my computer when I'm live. It runs everything slow. All right, forehand to forehand as Kyrgios goes down the line to the backhand slice of Nakashima. That goes in the forehand volley of Kyrgios. Nakashima with a lob. Kyrgios lets it bounce. And hits a smash to the forehand of Nakashima. Then Kyrgios hits it to the backhand of Nakashima. And Nakashima's backhand goes wide. 30 all. Kyrgios trying to get an early break in this fourth set. What happened to the Demon? I don't think it was anything to do with fatigue or anything. I think he just got beat by a guy who... unfortunately, Diminor sometimes does have that... does have those bad losses, unfortunately. I've noticed. You know, he's in a winning position and then, or even he has a chance to win a match in a big, and have a big opportunity to make a quarterfinals of Wimbledon, and then he stuffs it, you know. Credit Garen though. You got to credit the guy who came back. Garen's a beast. So much random players in the round of 16 on both the men and the women's. Yep. Do you know why that is? Does anyone know why there are so many random players? Does anyone know? There's only one reason why. Actually, no, there's two reasons. But does anyone know the main reason? 40-30. As Nakashima double faults. And Nakashima's double faults have been his downfall in this match. It cost him the first set. The second set. It cost him the third set. Yeah, the ban and obviously injuries. Yeah. Withdrawals. You know, Berrettini, RBA, Zverev. But... the Russian's not playing as well. I think that's the more... on the women's side, that's definitely the more... the Russian's not playing is why there's so many random women. Yeah, on the men's side, it's sort of 50-50, injuries and the ban. But on the women's side, it's mainly the ban. But yeah, it's... it is what it is. Wimbledon made a decision. And it's over now. I mean, there's no... I mean, we're playing the tournament. We're halfway through. It's all done now. Serve into the backhand of Kyrgios as Kyrgios hits a forehand flick into the backhand of Nakashima. Nakashima hits it in the net. Back to deuce. Back to deuce. Yeah, it shows how good Russians are at tennis. And Belarusians, you know, you got Azarenka, Sabalenka. They were you know, they wouldn't be a shock quarterfinalist if we had them this year. The Russian women, I mean, there's so many Russian women in the top 100. As that goes in the net from Kyrgios and it's advantage. Nakashima. Yeah, let me have a look and see what Pat Cash, what the quotes were about Kyrgios. I'm interested. I wonder what Kyrgios will say to Pat Cash. I'm sure he'll have something to say. As Nakashima wins the game with a lovely little shot in the open court. All right. Nakashima. 1-1. Now, so Pat Cash, he says about Kyrgios, he's brought tennis to the lowest level I can see as far as gamesmanship. cheating, manipulation, abuse, aggressive behavior to umpire, to linesman. And that's what he said. So Pat Cash coming out swinging. And look, hey, Cash is a legend. You know, he's won Wimbledon. Dude's an absolute beast. I'm a massive fan of Cashy, but doesn't mean I have to agree. I think that's a little bit over the top, but you know. Anyway, it's flying down the line. As Kyrgios losing the first point, Nakashima can't pass Keegs there, 15-all. I don't agree with Cashy. I respect him, but I don't agree with that. I think that's a little bit too much. A little bit over the top from Cashy. Got some. I mean, I'm sure he's got some, you know, some validity in there, but I don't agree with most of that. Some of you are going to say that's exactly what he 100% right, but you know, that's because you're 100% against Kyrgios, and that's fine too. We all have we all have our favorites. 30-15. And I wonder. I know, and every, you know what's going to happen. The first question in the press conference today is going to be, "Did you hear what Pat Cash said about you?" That's going to be the first question. You know it is in the press conference. Win, lose, or draw today, which can't be a draw, but win or lose, the first question will be, "Did you hear what Pat Cash said about you?" That'll be the first question. As that goes in the net from Kyrgios, it's 30-all. Yeah, Kat, look, the reason why Pat Cash is Pat Cash is of the old school. You know how I said earlier that in Australia, the majority of people that don't like Nick Kyrgios is because he doesn't represent our country on the world stage very well. And Cashy was one of the players that represented our country amazingly. So he is of that same mindset, you know, that old school mindset of, you know, you got to, every time you're playing with the flag in front of your name, you've got to, you know, You've got to represent that, you know, with pride and be like, you know, and be the shining example of Australian tennis, you know. If you're Australian, you're playing tennis. Leighton said something too. Well, let me know in the chat. Send me the Leighton quotes. I don't think Leighton said anything. Anyways, Keegs gets on the board again, stays in touch, 2-1. So this is what Cashy had. This is the full quote because, of course, articles pick and choose. So he said it was absolute mayhem, talking about the City Pass match. It was absolute mayhem. He was lucky to even get through the first set. He should have been defaulted in the first set. Something's got to be done about it. It's an absolute circus. He's brought the tennis to the lowest level I can see as far as gamesmanship, cheating, manipulation, abuse, aggression, aggressive behavior to umpires and to lines people. Then he said, is it entertaining? Yeah, possibly. It's gone to the absolute limit now. It's the gamesmanship, the abuse he is giving. Tsitsipas got sucked right into it, so it was entertaining and fascinating, but for me, it's gone too far. I have no problems with a bit of gamesmanship, but when it gets to that level, I think it's out of control. So there you go. That was Cashy. That's a full quote from Pat Cash. Now, Mats Wilander also had to say something as well, who, funny enough, beat Pat Cash back in the day at the Australian Open in a couple of finals. I've never seen anything like it. I'm not sure I want to see something like that again, to be honest, because I don't think this is what we need to promote in tennis. He goes on to say, this is Wilander, goes on to say, we do not want to promote it as entertainment. We want to promote it as inspirational, educational. I'm not sure I'm a big fan of what's going on, to be honest. It's embarrassing. Nick Kyrgios doesn't need to do all this. It's scary how good he is. That's why it's sad in a way. And that's what McEnroe said. It's embarrassing. He doesn't need to do all this. It's scary how good he is. That's the sad thing about it. There you go. Now, is that boomer talk? Let me know in the chat. Is that they're all from the same generation. Is it a generational thing? Or is it... I mean, look, I respect the hell out of all those guys. So I listen when they speak. The spitting was, the spitting was, the spitting is disgusting. If you spit at somebody, that's disgusting. And when when someone said Kyrgios spit at the crowd or whatever he did, you can't defend that. That's disgusting. But what do you reckon? Let me know in the chat. Are you a fan of, do you listen to those guys and go 100% right? Or do you go 100% wrong? Or do you go, like, I look at those and I go, I see where they're coming from. I see where they're coming from. And I see what they mean. I don't agree with all of what they say, but I see where they're coming from. But I also disagree with some of what they say as well. You know, but I respect what they're saying. 30-15. Yeah, I think with Verlander saying it's educational, that makes tennis sound like it's like school, and people don't like school. So I think calling tennis educational is a little bit like, oh, I have to study. Like, that kind of will turn people off tennis if it's educational. I think that's a poor choice of words. But inspirational, yeah. There's a bit of volley there from Nakashima at 30-15. Now it's 40-15. To get to 2-2. Lovely volley there. Yeah, I'm kind of like, I agree with some of what they say, but I also disagree. I think some of it's like they're speaking a little bit. They're getting a little bit. I think there is a happy medium. But I respect what those guys say. I mean, they're the legends of our game. I mean, when they talk, we listen. You have to. Anyways, Nakashima gets a 2-2 in this fourth set. Yeah, the only reason why I say is it generational is because those guys were the best players in the 70s and 80s. We're in 2020. We're in the 2020s now. Those guys played 40 years ago. 40 years ago, those guys were at the top of their game, right? And should tennis be the same as it was 40 years ago? Or should it evolve with the times? And should it evolve with other sports? I mean, 40 years ago, the world was a very different place. That's why I say, is it a generational thing? You know, it was a different time for when they played. Are they saying this, like, they want tennis to be like it was when they played? Is that what they're saying? Like, that's where I kind of go, I don't think, if they're coming from the, you know, they're saying, this is not back in my day, you know, that kind of thing, then I'm like, well, 2020 is a different world. You know, social media is obviously the big difference. Internet, culture, you know, drama is a big deal. Like, drama, you know, reality TV is, you know, all that shit. It's a totally different world these days. Back in the 80s, 70s and 80s, it wasn't about, you know, it was about watching, you know, game shows on TV. And it wasn't like, you know, you didn't have the Kardashians. You didn't have, you know, social media and influences and popularity and fame and all that crap that comes along with today's day. You know what I mean? So, yeah. So, but again, like I said, I'm sort of 50-50. I'm in the middle. I see what they've said and I'm like, yeah, okay, I can see where they're coming from. You know, as legends of the game. There's a bit of drop shot there from Keegs. That's too good. 30-15. Anyways. Great drop shot. But keep telling me in the chat what you guys think. Johnny Mac was the original and way worse. Yeah, it is interesting McEnroe saying that it's a disgrace. And it's like, excuse me. What? Hang on a second. When you, like, I feel like Kyrgios isn't abusive to umpires. To like, that's not what, he's not abusive to umpires. Like, that, He's very, he's intimidating, and he's definitely uses intimidation at times. But I wouldn't say he's abusive. He doesn't say, I will beat the hell out of you. Like, you know, Kyrgios, I don't think he's abusive to the umpires or lines people. He doesn't threaten to hurt people. He just complains. So I don't know where the abuse part comes from. He's very intimidating, though, to the umpires. I definitely agree with that. He definitely intimidates. Anyways, 3-2, Kyrgios with an ace. I don't know if he's cheating. I don't know what is cheating. Is it cheating what he's doing? I mean, I don't know if he's cheating. Anyways, I kind of agree and disagree. Yeah, he's just rude. But I don't think he threatens, abusive is, I don't think he threatens umpires. But then he is like verbally abusive, so there you go. You're totally right, gotta respect the legends of the game. Yeah. But I do think like, it'd probably be different if I saw like Leighton Hewitt or Andy Roddick or Roger Federer. Someone who's a little bit more, someone who's been a part of the last 20 years say it. I feel like they've got a little bit more, they can understand it better. Like if Andy Roddick said, Nick Kyrgios is a disgrace and this is bad. And then like, I feel like those guys are still relevant. But I feel like in terms of today's game, if someone like Andy Roddick said that about Kyrgios, I'd be like, oh, okay. Because he's a little bit closer to the, like, you know, recently retired, well, in the last decade, you know. I would listen to Andy Roddick a little bit more just because he's been a part of this internet generation, right? And this, you know, because as much as Kyrgios shows all that, you know, does all this crap, I mean, he gets abused 10 times more on Instagram, on Twitter, all that other stuff. So it's like, you know, so I respect what they say and you got to listen to those guys. You don't have to agree with them. But if Leighton Hewitt or Andy Roddick or someone of this generation or the previous, you know, 10 years came out and said it, I'd be like, oh, okay. Because those guys know. You know, those guys have been around for this whole thing, you know. Some of them play Kyrgios, you know. It's a... All right, anyways, let's get back to this match. Thank you for bringing that up, though, because it was very interesting comments by a lot of the greats of the game. As that goes wide from Keegs, and it's 30 love. How is Kyrgios seen in Australia? That's something that's really funny, because people that are like, so 90% of the people that are over 40 years old hate him. People that are under 30... So people that are between 25 and 40, they either love or hate him. It's sort of a 50-50. Some people don't like him. Some people like him. And people, it seems like the kids love him. Like people are under 25, majority that somewhat enjoy tennis, always try, like they love watching him. They love it. So that's you know, the kids that I coach that watch tennis, which is rare, but some of them that watch tennis are like, Kyrgios is awesome. So it's sort of, again, it depends on how old, like, I'm not saying everyone who's over 40 is anti-Kyrgios, because that's not true. But there's a strong dislike for Kyrgios, who are people that are over the age of 40. If you say, you know, Nick Kyrgios, people go, oh, I hate that guy. That's the first reaction to most people, for most people in Australia. It's like, oh, I hate that guy. That guy sucks. Not everyone, but a lot. And then the younger demographic seem to like him more. I don't know if that's a thing. Go figure, right? Anyways, 40-15. Turns into 40-30 as Keegs hits a lovely return.
Classy, educated treatment of umpires by Sir John McEnroe. Smiley face. A-OK.
Thank you, Elena, for the 12. Yeah, yeah. It's funny when Mac talks about behavior on court. That's when it is funny. It's like, oh, okay. So all of a sudden, now we're listening to John McEnroe talk about tennis etiquette. That's when things get funny. It's like, oh, now we're going to take behavioral advice off John McEnroe, who made basically, I mean, he's made a career off being known for his outbursts. I mean, look at that, right? If John McEnroe had not done those things, would we remember him as much? Maybe not. We'd remember him for his great play, but his outbursts are what made him infamous. And he's now saying that those things are bad. Let's go figure, right? Look, you can change your opinions, but you know, as you get older, you don't have to be like, well, I was once a kid and I'm, you know, now I'm an adult and I'm thinking the same way. John McEnroe's matured, but it is a little bit funny to hear him say, like, you know, that Kyrgios is outrageous, and he's like, so, dude, what about, do you remember what you did? Unless he says what he did was outrageous too. But then again, he's got to thank that for, because he wouldn't be the guy that he is today if it wasn't for those things, right? You know, if he wasn't the guy, if John McEnroe was quiet and respectful, we wouldn't remember him as much. We'd only remember him from his trophies. There's been a four-in rally, kind of like Edberg, right? Edberg doesn't get talked in the same breath as McEnroe because McEnroe was crazy. Backhand to backhand. There's been a slice now from Keegs into the backhand of Nakashima. It's four-in now. Let's get back to this match because things are starting to get really interesting as Keegs hits it out. 15-30. Nakashima, not done yet. Not done yet. He's not done yet. As Nakashima, 15-30. He hasn't broken since the first set. Actually, no break points since the first set. Against either guy. Second serve. Second serve. 15-30. Serve to the forehand of Nakashima. Forehand from Kyrgios is into the backhand of Nakashima. Backhand from Kyrgios down the line. Nakashima on the forehand side gets it. Forehand from Keegs down the line is wide. We're getting a challenge.
That ball was on the line. Chalk flew up.
We're getting a challenge. We get a challenge. As that goes wide, it's two break points for Nakashima. Nick Kyrgios has no challenges remaining. And he's only halfway through the fourth. 15-40, serve out wide of the forehand of Nakashima. Forehand from Kyrgios to the backhand of Nakashima. Into the backhand of Kyrgios. Again, the backhand of Nakashima. Backhand from Keegs is wide. Nakashima breaks, 4-3. In the fourth. All right. Nakashima breaks. Let's go around the courts because I need to go to the bathroom. Nakashima breaks, 4-3, as we get a serve down to the back of the Keegs. That goes into the forehand of Nakashima. Back in from Kyrgios in the net. 15, love, we're going 5 sets. If Nakashima can win 2 more games. By the way, happy 4th of July to everybody out there. Fritz is up 2 sets to love against Kubler. No surprise there. Dimonor lost from a 2 set to love lead against Garin. That was a surprise. And it looks like Tomanovich is on as well. There's a backhand now from Kyrgios into the backhand of Nakashima. Backhand from Keegs. Again to the slice of Nakashima. And that goes in the net from Nakashima. 15-0. By the way, I just saw the schedule for tomorrow. Wimbledon. Wimbledon are very weird with their schedules. But hey, I guess Wimbledon want to double dip on the crowds and get 2 stadiums full of people. But to be honest, no disrespect, but the German matchup is not very exciting. Norrie Goffin on court number one. That's a bit disrespectful for Doc Norrie. As that goes in the net there from Nakashima, 15-30. 15-30. Winner of this will play Christian Garin in the quarterfinals. Quarterfinals on Wednesday. Serving out of the back end of Kyrgios. Backing out from Nakashima is a winner. 30-all. Nice from Nakashima. Nakashima again. He's been like this the whole day. A couple of double faults at bad times, but emotionally, he has just been a rock. As we get an ace down the tee from Nakashima. 40-30. As we just serve down to the forehand of Kyrgios. Backhand out from Nakashima to the forehand of Keegs. Into the forehand of Nakashima. Again to the forehand of Kyrgios. To the backhand of Nakashima. Backhand out from Kyrgios. Down the line. Nakashima with the forehand into the net. Deuce. Can Kyrgios break back? Get back on serve straight away. Serve now Nakashima. Down the tee, great serve. Kyrgios gets it back, but it goes long. Advantage Nakashima. Advantage Nakashima to get. To get the 5-3 lead. There's a bit of serve out wide. That's a fault. Second serve. 2.5 hours played. There's a bit of serve out wide to the backhand of Kyrgios. Backhand now from Nakashima to the forehand of Keegs. Into the backhand of Nakashima. Again to the forehand of Kyrgios. Who goes cross court at the forehand of Nakashima. Forehand from Kyrgios down the line is long. Nakashima 5-3. Hold on to your butts. We're going 5. If Nakashima can win one more game. Okay. 5-3 Nakashima to take us to a 5th. Kyrgios serving to stay in the set. Serve out wide to the forehand of Nakashima. Backhand from Keegs into the drop shot of Nakashima and Kyrgios turns away. Nakashima, what a shot. Love 15. Serve goes into the backhand of Nakashima. Backhand out from Kyrgios in the net. Love 30. I feel like Keegs has to win this game here. To serve first in the 5th. Serving second could cost him. As he serves down the tee, a very soft first serve. What the hell was that? And then he hits a forehand out. Oh no. Love 40. Kyrgios has thrown this game away. As we're backing down the line and Nakashima can't get it. 15-40. This is what Nakashima got in the first game, or the first set, I should say. Serve out wide of the forehand of Nakashima. Forehand from Kyrgios into the backhand of Nakashima. And that goes long from Nakashima. 30-40. Kyrgios ready to serve. First serve is a fault. Second serve. Into the forehand of Nakashima. Forehand from Kyrgios is wide. There we go. Five sets. And that game was exactly what Kyrgios did at the end of the first set. He just kind of went, oh, whatever. Threw it away. And Nakashima is serving first in the fifth, which I think could prove the difference. All right. We're going five on this Independence Day. It was weird, but then we also saw it earlier. All right. Kyrgios gives that set to Nakashima, and we're going to a five. By the way, if you are joining us for the first time today, welcome. It's just been one of them days. Nick Kyrgios has had a bad shoulder since we started, and he really hasn't. I mean, he hasn't been animated. There's been no arguments, no disagreements, no nothing. Kyrgios has been very tame in comparison because he's been focusing on the shoulder the whole time. But, yeah, I mean, it's been a strange match. Nakashima's been a rock. Kyrgios has been a roller coaster in, not in emotion, but in his ability today. No circus today. Nakashima with a fist bump. He is showing a little bit of emotion here. Nakashima can make a semi-final of Wimbledon. Don't you get it twisted. He wins today. Semi-finals, potentially, if he can get through Garin. So, Nakashima knows what's up. All right. Kyrgios prefers a hyper opponent. I think Kyrgios prefers, like, I mean, look, we've seen Kyrgios play his best tennis against the best players. And he's also played some of his worst tennis against the not-so-good players. Or the lower ranked players.
Man, you better shut your fuck up, okay?
And then you hit left and you don't say sorry, you think you're a good kid?
I told you to stop and you kept doing like this to the team.
It's a bullshit Russian, you think this is normal?
Hey, thank you, Robert, for the 10. Appreciate that. Thank you for the 10, thank you for the super sticker, appreciate that. All right, Nakashima serving first in this fifth. Who's winning this match? Who is winning this match? I'm leaning Nakashima. I think serving first is a big deal. In the final set, I'm leaning Nakashima. 15 love as Kyrgios hits a forehand on the stretch. And that goes wide. Nakashima serves. Out wide of the forehand of Kyrgios, and that goes long. 40 love. Winner of this place, Christian Garin, in the quarterfinals. As he serves out wide, Nakashima, a fault. Second serve. Second serve into the backhand of Kyrgios. Backhand from Nakashima into the forehand of Kyrgios is a winner. Lovely shot from Keegs. 40-15. 40-15. Nice flick there from Kyrgios into the court. Just a little rollover with the flick. As Nakashima serves. Serves out wide of the slice forehand of Kyrgios and Kyrgios hits it out. Nakashima, first game of the fifth. First game of the fifth to Nakashima. Okay. First game of the final set. So the schedule for tomorrow is Djokovic on first on center court. And then followed that by Jabeur on second. On court number one, they've got Maria versus Niemeyer, followed by Goffin versus Norrie. So it's the only tournament in the world that have the quarterfinals on at the same time. Everywhere else in the world, they have them one at a time. But at Wimbledon, they have them overlapping. So we'll figure out what we do tomorrow. Obviously, watching the center court matches, obviously, because they're the big ones, aren't they? So, but it's a little odd that, you know, Wimbledon wouldn't just like have all the quarterfinals on at this, you know, give each quarterfinal its due, you know, like every other tournament in the world. All right, love 15. As we had a backhand now from Kyrgios, that goes out, love 30. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Love 30. Love 30. As Kyrgios throws that ball away in anger. I think Kyrgios is a little bit frustrated here. We haven't seen that yet. He's been pretty quiet. Compared to usual.
Today is Aussie Heartbreak Day.
Why? Why are you gonna be like that? Why are you gonna do that? Why are you gonna do that to me? Anyways, Kyrgios serves an ace. 15-30. She has another ace. 30 all. Bang bang. The Dimonor one sucks. I don't expect Kubler to win. I mean, if anyone thought Kubler was gonna win, would be very delusional and very optimistic. Tom Anovich should win. I think she can win. Dimonor should have won. He was the lock for us. As that goes in from Kyrgios, great volley, and it's 40-30. Dimonor was the one that I was like, that's the one that we should win. The other ones, this one included, you know, Dimonor was the only one that was that should have won. And Kyrgios should win too, but you know, the way he's been playing all day, we know that probably, you know, might not happen. As he puts a forehand out of the backhand of Nakashima down the line. What a shot!
Unbelievable.
What a shot! And Tomanovic can beat Cornet, but I don't know if she will. She won't be the favorite. The two favorites were obviously the two boys here.
Unbelievable. No.
Unbelievable.
Unbelievable.
Yeah, unbelievable.
It's unbelievable.
I don't care about what I was saying.
Hey, thank you. I can't pronounce your name, but thank you for the what's NT? 170 NT. What's NT? Does anyone know what's NT? Anyways, thank you for the donation. Appreciate the five. Lovely forehand of the open court for Kyrgios on the run. Advantage. Keegs to get level in this final set. Taiwanese dollar. Oh, thank you. Appreciate the new Taiwanese dollar. Appreciate that. Thank you. Advantage Kyrgios to level up here in the fifth. As we're returning the net from Nakashima. And Kyrgios stays in this set. So yeah, if I had to pick out of the four Aussies today, I would say Dimonor and Kyrgios were the two winners. They were the ones who should win. And I would say Kubler, no chance. And Tomanovic has a 50-50 chance. So far, Kubler's getting whooped, so no surprise. Dimonor lost, that was tough. This one with Kyrgios being hurt, that sucks. Tomanovic could still win. You know, Cornet coming off the biggest win of her career. The biggest win of this year. Not her career because she's beaten Serena, but biggest win of the year. You can do have a letdown sometimes. All right. 15 love. Let's stay with this, though. Serve down to the forehand of Keegs. Forehand out from Nakashima to the forehand of Keegs. Again to the forehand of Nakashima. Backhand of Kyrgios. Again to the backhand of Nakashima. Into the backhand of Kyrgios. To the backhand of Nakashima. As Kyrgios goes with the backhand cross court again. Slice Nakashima. Up comes Kyrgios with a forehand. Nakashima with a pass. Kyrgios with a tweener, but it's in the net. He was going to hit a normal volley and he went numb and hit it between the legs. And he didn't have enough time. Just a silly mistake from Keegs. 30 love. He just didn't ready him. He could have probably hit that shot between the legs had he had readied himself. Yeah, Parker Ash, that tweener was... You could tell that he went to do a normal volley and then he changed his mind. And by that time, he already had been too late. Would have been a fun one if he had not, you know, picked that shot first. Anyways, backhand now from Kyrgios, 30 love. He's got a backhand now to the forehand, and that goes out from Nakashima. 30-15. First serve is a fault. Second serve. Serve goes to the back end of Kyrgios. Backhand now from Nakashima. Into the back end of Kyrgios. Backhand now Nakashima. Down the line is a winner. Nice from Nakashima. But he's going to challenge Keegs.
That ball was on the line. Shot flew up.
It was in. But he's challenging anyway, Kyrgios. 40-15 for Nakashima. And that ball was on the line. 40-15. Nakashima to get back in the lead here. Nakashima serves. A fault. Oof, just. Second serve. Second serve. Out wide of the forehand of Keegs. Forehand Nakashima is out. 40-30. In this fifth set. If you're just joining us, Nick Kyrgios, since the first set, has had a sore shoulder. And it's causing problems throughout the match at different times. As Nakashima hits a lovely volley, Kyrgios gets it with the forehand down the line. Nakashima can't get it. Kyrgios, lovely shot.
This is going to be on Tennis TV, bro.
And he gets the deuce. And the crowd are getting involved a little bit more here. I feel like the crowd's been like a non-factor today. Like they've not been here or there. They've just kind of been like mid. Lovely shot from Keegs. As we get to deuce, Nakashima serves. A fault, second serve. Second serve, to the back end of Kyrgios. Backhand from Nakashima, to the back end of Keegs. Into the back end of Nakashima. Again to the back end of Kyrgios. Forehand Nakashima, into the forehand of Kyrgios. To the backhand of Nakashima. Backhand from Keegs, again to the forehand of Nakashima, to the back end of Kyrgios. Into the forehand of Nakashima. The forehand now of Kyrgios. Nakashima doing all the work here. Kyrgios gets the point though. Nakashima hits it out. Advantage Kyrgios. The first break point since the second set for Keegs. Now Nakashima gave that second set away by double folding early in that second set to give the break up, and that was enough. The third break point of the day against Nakashima. The first since the second set. Huge chance for Keegs. Nakashima with the serve. Is an ace. Oh, that's clutch.
Unbelievable.
That's clutch. Now Nick's going to challenge. Challenge from Keegs, but I think it was in. It was good. Nakashima was pretty adamant. That was inside. Inside the lines. Didn't even hit the line. Chalk didn't fly up. And we get to deuce. And now Kyrgios is starting to talk to the umpire. We haven't seen this all day. Keegs is saying to the umpire. Oh, there's an argument. Kyrgios is getting involved with the umpire now. This might actually help Kyrgios, which is kind of weird. But that's the first sign. First sign of any sort of conversation. Kyrgios has been very quiet today. He's been a good boy. He's been on his best behavior, but not on purpose. All right, back to Deuce. I think he was pissed off because the umpire said he didn't know if it was in or not. And Kyrgios was like, how could you not know? How could you not see that? It was in by a mile. I think Keegs is a little bit annoyed. All right, great return, by the way, from Keegs. And he gets a break point. All right, Kyrgios, bingo. He was arguing with the umpire. Cross that off the list. Arguing with the umpire. So we have the bingo card. We're getting our ass whooped today in bingo. I mean, geez, we're not getting nothing today. No code violations, no nothing. Anyways, Nakashima down break point again as he hits a forehand into the forehand slice of Kyrgios. Forehand from Nakashima is in the net. Nick Kyrgios breaks 2-1. And I think Kyrgios has a little bit more energy after that. A little fire in the belly after that exchange with the umpire. That might have just ignited a little fire. And he's going to take it. Is he going to keep going? Is Keegs going to keep going? No. He's going to keep it. No, he is. He's talking to the umpire still. And this might ignite Kyrgios because he has been flat all day. And he might forget about the shoulder. And the umpire is trying to justify that he didn't see the ball, which is kind of weird because that's kind of his job. Anyways, questions.
Will you answer my question? Can you answer my question, please?
Okay. Blah, blah, blah. Bingo's priceless. Hey, look, we're going to play bingo next time Kyrgios plays because I feel today we're being kind of screwed over with the bingo. So if you're just joining us, we were playing bingo, Kyrgios bingo. You know, we've been playing this for about 2 years. It's been a bingo game that we've played for a while. But he hasn't smashed a racket. He hasn't shouted at his coach's box. No second serve over 200 Ks. Has he had a minute service game? Probably, but we haven't seen it enough to know that. Swearing, he hasn't really sworn. He hasn't said, I'm not playing. He hasn't talked to the crowd, and he hasn't got a code violation yet. So we've still got a fair way to go, but he has done a trick shot, a tweener. He has done an underarm serve, and he has just argued with the umpire. So we're trying to get bingo. Let's see how we go. Let's see if he brings all of those things to the table in the end here. 15 love, Keegs. Play along at home if you want. As Kyrgios hits a good serve, he comes in with a smash, puts it away. And puts it away. 30 love. Kyrgios just broke for the first time since the second set. So big stuff. As Kyrgios serves a fault, second serve. Also, it looks like Kubler's come back against Fritz in the third set. Good to see him putting up a bit of a fight. That Aussie spirit. There's a bit of slice there from Nakashima into the forehand of Kyrgios. To the forehand of Nakashima. Down the line to the slice of Kyrgios. Nakashima lets it bounce into the forehand of Nakashima. Forehand from Keegs. Nakashima in control. As Kyrgios goes side to side. Slice from Nakashima now to the slice of Kyrgios into the forehand of Nakashima. Kyrgios with a pass is in the net. As Kyrgios looks to get the 3-1 lead in the fifth set, consolidate that break. Serve down the tee. The forehand is a great serve from Keegs. In the net from Nakashima, 40-15. So Kubes is up, is in 3-all against Fritz. So he's, again, fighting back. Tomanovic is down a break against Cornet in the first set. Give it a serve out wide. An ace from Kyrgios. 3-1 Keegs. 3-1 Keegs in the final set of this absolute, I mean, this is an epic match on the scoreboard. It's not the match that we saw the other day. I guess that's a good thing. You know, you don't want every match to be, you want, like, I'm a Kyrgios fan, and I enjoy the circus every now and again, but I don't enjoy going to the circus every day. I also enjoy great tennis. And we're getting that today. We're getting a very fun match between two guys who have very different personalities. Serve out wide is good. Into the back end now from Nakashima. He comes to the net. Kyrgios with a pass. Nakashima with a volley. Kyrgios is going to get there with a pass. Nakashima in the net. Kyrgios too quick. Love 15. Love 15. Lovely shot from Keegs. Just good running. As Nakashima can't afford to go down double break. Not against Kyrgios to serve. Good return to the slice. Nakashima. Forehand from Kyrgios in the net. 15 all. So the winner of this will play Christian Garin in the quarterfinals, which is a great opportunity for one of these lads to get to the semis. I think the winner of this match will be the favorite against Garin. As we're to serve down to see the slice of Kyrgios. Forehand from Nakashima. Into the forehand of Kyrgios. Again to the forehand of Nakashima. Backhand Keegs. Again to the backhand of Nakashima. Backhand to backhand as Keegs pushes it to the backhand of Nakashima. Another backhand from Keegs. Nakashima's backhand as well. As Keegs just keeps going to the backhand of Nakashima. Now we're slicing it. A drop shot for Kyrgios. Nakashima with a forehand in the net. 15-30. Kyrgios now is just outsmarting Nakashima. Not with power, but with shot making, placement. 15-30. Nakashima under a lot of pressure now. Double break. I mean, Kyrgios can give away a lead, but double break in a fifth set, you don't want to be in that position. As we had a backhand rally, Nakashima goes in the net again. Oh no. Nakashima's lost his legs. Nakashima's lost his legs. He looks stuffed, Nakashima. He's been a workhorse, absolutely solid all day, but he's starting to lose his legs. 15-40. Nakashima's getting tired. As he serves. A fault. Second serve. Second serve in the back of Kyrgios, and that's in the net on the return from Keegs. 30-40. Saves one. This has been a three-hour match, so it's not been the longest five-setter of all time, but Nakashima definitely, you can tell, is just not moving as well, and he looks tired after hitting shots. As he serves now the forehand of Kyrgios, that goes out on the return. And it's deuce. Nakashima survives. Kyrgios, by the way, talks to the crowd. We're going to get to that in a second because that's on the card. Serve is a fault. Second serve. We're going to cross off talking to the crowd. Second serve into the back end of Kyrgios. That's a great return. Slice from Nakashima. Just gets it to the back end of Kyrgios. Forehand from Nakashima is wide. And Kyrgios gets another break point. Advantage Keegs to take the double break. All right. Advantage. Nick Kyrgios to take that 4-1 lead. Serve now Nakashima. Here's a fault. Uh-oh.
Can't buy a first serve.
It's a fault. Second serve. Serving to the back of Kyrgios. That goes into the forehand of Nakashima. Forehand from Kyrgios on the stretch. Nakashima gets it. Kyrgios in control as he puts it back into the open court for a winner. Oh, Nick Kyrgios is fired up here. That's the first sign of emotion. That's what we want to see from Keegs. Some care. Some fire. And he's fired up, Keegs. He's like, I'm going to the quarters, baby. Let's get it. Bring me Garen. Love to see that energy from Kyrgios. Positivity. Now, he already did talk to the crowd, so we'll cross that off too. I don't think we're going to get bingo today, but we might get another chance to play bingo in a couple of days. But man, fired up Kyrgios. That's good. You love to see that. That positive energy coming from Keegs. He's saying, let's go, let's go. That's what you want to see from Keegs. We haven't seen that as long as I can remember. All right. Nakashima is going to come back from a long way. A long way back. Let's see what he can do. He's got to come back from a long way. Now, if you're just joining us, Nick Kyrgios has been battling a shoulder problem all day. It's been hurting him at certain stages of this match. He's had he had a medical timeout, all that stuff. But, I mean, right now, the adrenaline is pumping. And I think Nakashima's starting to cramp because he looks a bit sore. Stretching out the legs. Nick Kyrgios. Serving for a 5-1 lead in the fifth. He serves out wide of the forehand of Nakashima. Volley from Kyrgios in the net. Love 15. By the way, Seal is in the chat. I mean, in the stands. He's not in the chat. Can you imagine? He's in the stands. 15 all as that goes out from Nakashima on the return. They zoom in on Seal. Seal. 15 all. Seal in the chat. Return now goes into the forehand of Kyrgios, and Kyrgios puts it away. 30-15. Keegs is 6 points away from another quarterfinal at Wimbledon. If this was worth, if this was worth points, my God, would Kyrgios be back with a vengeance, back in that top 30? God, it sucks so bad. Wimbledon screwed over a lot of people by not giving points away. Kyrgios would have been in the top 30, maybe even close to 20. There's been a forehand from Keegs down the line to the backhand of Nakashima. Forehand from Keegs into the forehand of Nakashima. Sliced. To the forehand of Kyrgios. Again, to the forehand of Nakashima. To the forehand of Kyrgios. But Nakashima hits it out. 40-15. 5 points away, Keegs. And Kyrgios looks like he might get out of this match and get to a quarterfinal against clay court Garen. I mean, what the hell is that going to look like? Keegs with the serve. Down the season ace. Nick Kyrgios has got his mojo back. At the right time as well. And how, like I said at the start of this set, how important was that little interaction with the umpire to give him that fire? Because he hasn't touched his shoulder since the fourth set. After that interaction, that little bit of adrenaline, that little bit of aggression, it's done him all the good in this set, because he's come out with an absolute fire in this set, and he's dominating as he hits a return there. Kyrgios to the forehand of Nakashima, and Nakashima puts away. 15 love. as we're served now from Nakashima to the forehand of Kyrgios. Backing out Nakashima to the forehand of Keegs, who smacks a winner. He's not messing about. He is not messing about, Kyrgios, in this final set. Not messing about. By the way, I just want to say a happy 4th of July to all the Americans out there. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. We have a big match coming on after this between Simona Halep and Paola Badosa. So make sure you subscribe so you can join us for that. And we're going to keep an eye on what Fritz and Kubler are doing, because Kubler and Fritz, similar to this battle, American versus Australian, as Keegs puts that in the net. After it was a double fault. Oh no. By the way, is Nakashima's coach looks so much like Fernandez's coach. Does anyone else get that vibe? They look so similar. Is it the same person? Surely not. All right, 15-30. Return from Kyrgios goes into the forehand, a slice of Nakashima. Backhand now from Kyrgios is wide. Nakashima survives, 30-all. In Britain, we say happy treason day to all our Americans. That sounds like a sore loser to me. It sounds like a bad, sore loser to me. Holy shit, Magneto's in the house! Magneto! Gandalf is in the house! As we had a forehand now from Nakashima. Oh my god! Somebody see Gandalf's in the house! Holy shit! Didn't know Magneto liked tennis. Anyways, 40-30. Gandalf's watching! 40-30. Crazy stuff. Hang on, is Gandalf the new coach of Kyrgios? Confirmed? What? That is crazy. Holy shit. Serve. Out wide of the back of the Keegs. Good shot down to the point of... Oh, great shot from Nakashima. Almost makes Kyrgios fall over. 5-2. Nakashima survives for one more game. But Nick Kyrgios is going to serve for the match after this.
Answer my question! The question, jerk!
It's only treason if you lose. You sure that was him? Pretty sure. I'm pretty sure it was him. I mean, why would they show just a random old guy in the royal box that looks similar to Gandalf? I mean, I'm sure it was him. Unless they just found a doppelganger. What else we got? I was just thinking the same thing about winners in the match. No, what? Kyrgios wins against Garin in straight sets, you reckon? I don't know. Garin is not to be, underestimated. Gandalf healed Keegs. Confirmed. Gandalf put a spell on Kyrgios to make him win this last set. Gandalf, Kyrgios fan confirmed. You think Fritz can beat Rafa? Maybe. Possibly. I reckon Fritz could trouble Rafa, yes. I don't know if he could beat him, but he could trouble him. By the way, speaking of Fritz, he's got match points. As Kyrgios serves for the match, return goes in the forehand of Keegs. Backhand now Nakashima slice the forehand of Kyrgios into the backhand, but it's wide by Keegs. Fritz hasn't lost a set. Going to play Rafa Nadal having not lost a set. That is confidence. And that's something that I think Taylor Fritz will thrive off. I'm going to say it. Taylor Fritz can beat Rafa. He can beat Rafa. Sorry, Rafa fans. I know you're probably going to like come at me and be like, how dare you? How dare you? But hey. I'm just stating facts, mate. As that's a forehand. Oh, Nakashima with a winner. Love 30. To get one back. Triggered? Oh no, I've triggered them. I've triggered the minions. Uh-oh. Rafa Army. No, don't hurt me, Rafa Army. He did beat him in Indian Wells, exactly. As we're going to return now from Nakashima to the forehand of Keegs. Slice from Nakashima to the forehand of Kyrgios. Again to the forehand of Nakashima. On the stretch. Keith with a drop shot. Nakashima runs. Gets it. What a shot. Kyrgios pass. Oh, Kyrgios pass.
This is going to be on Tennis TV, bro.
Kyrgios with a pass. 15-30. What a shot. What a shot. Oh, man. Lovely from Keegs. Nakashima had a very nice slice, but Kyrgios with a flick. Winner. That was a RAFA shot. Ha ha. 15-30. So about one of the back of the Nakashima, back in Kyrgios, the forehand of Nakashima, into the back of Kyrgios, to the slice of Nakashima, forehand from Keegs, again to the forehand of Nakashima, to the forehand of Kyrgios, down the line, to the back end of Nakashima, forehand from Keegs, again to the back end of Nakashima in the net, 30-all, 30-all. 2 points away, Keegs, from the dub. Don't forget to subscribe, if you haven't already. We're going to be back watching RAFA very soon against Van der Zandschulp. So before RAFA plays Fritz, he's got to beat Van der Zandschulp. We're going to watch all of that coming up next. Well, actually, no, he's coming up later. But the ladies are up next and then RAFA. So stay tuned. 30-all. Keegs. Serve. Down the tee. It's too good.
This is going to be on Tennis TV.
Too big, too strong. Nick Kyrgios gets match point. And he's had a bad shoulder for 4 out of the 5 sets. The 5th set, Gandalf put a spell on him. And it worked. You had to be there. If you don't know what I'm saying, you had to be there. 40-30. Match point. Serve out wide is a fault from Keegs. Second serve. Second serve. Is he going to go for the ace? Kind of. As he volleys. And Kyrgios is into the quarterfinals. And he screams to the crowd. He says, let's for Keenan go. Let's for Keenan go. Nick Kyrgios wins in 5. Dimonor didn't win. Kyrgios did. The Aussies get 1. And he says to the crowd, all right. Cheer me now. Keegs will play Garin in the quarterfinals. Nick Kyrgios survives. He survives himself. His shoulder. And he's into the quarterfinals, baby.
The show goes on.
The show goes on.
I'm not fucking leaving.
He's not leaving. Ha ha.
The show goes on!
The circus is still staying in town. All right, now Nakashima, let's credit him because you guys are saying, what's Nakashima about? What's he up to? What's the go? Nakashima is legit. 20-year-old American, must watch. Must watch. A must watch in the future. Nakashima is legit. But Nick Kyrgios, this man got a little fire at the start of the 5th because of that interaction with the umpire. And that was it. That's what it was. That little back and forth with the umpire stoked a little fire. And it was enough for Kyrgios to win. Okay. Don't forget to subscribe if you're leaving us. If you are leaving us, don't forget to sub. Like the video on the way out as well. We've got the ladies coming up next. The ladies are coming up next. We're going to stick around for a little bit though because we've got some time to hang out for about, well, we'll hang out for a fraction, for a little bit. Whoops.
Answer my question! The question, jerk!
All right, Halep versus Badosa next. I mean, you thought this match was good? Wait for that one. That one's going to be absolutely blockbuster. All right. Nakashima now 12-14 on the year. No, he would have won more matches this week. He would have been maybe... He would be in the positive this week. He was 12-13 going into this match before the tournament. So he'd be like 15-15 going now. All right. Some people talking like Nakashima was the favorite. Nakashima was the favorite. In the like after winning the going into the fifth, I think he was anyway. For me, he was. Nakashima was definitely. I mean, maybe some bad experience, like you know, less lack of experience. But Keegs didn't look good for most of this match. He looked sore. A lot of errors. I mean, looks if it wasn't for the serve. 42 errors, that's a lot. Nakashima, solid though. He'll get better. Nakashima's one to watch for sure. He's legit. Yeah, Nakashima's legit. Fourth round of Wimbledon, who would have thought? Keegs gives it up to Brandon Classy. Yeah. He knows when he plays against a good player. Keegs gives their... I mean, he even said he loved Tsitsipas before Tsitsipas trashed him in the press conference. we already talked about Cash's comments on Kyrgios at length, so go rewatch the video. We already talked about that so much. It's just, it's kind of, I don't want to go over the same shit all the time. I think he's got some points, Cashy, but I also don't agree with some of it. Kyrgios says to the umpire, "Can't you make a bad call so I can get something to get mad at?" Well, that's what worked. That's what worked. It did actually help Kyrgios. That interaction helped Kyrgios, and it's crazy. The match was closer than I had expected. Nakashima was an underdog? Yeah, for sure. For sure Nakashima was an underdog. All right, everybody. It's time to go and watch the next match. Now, you know what the drill is. I'm going to send you over there. Jump on there. We've got Badassa taking on Halep. That is the next matchup. I'm so fired up for it. I'm so fired up. I think that's the match of the day. If this one wasn't the match of the day, I mean, the next one has to be. It's got to be match of the day. I mean, it's absolute fire, the next match. Two genuine chances of winning Wimbledon are up against each other. So let me just get my trusty link. And you guys can jump over and say, talk amongst yourselves. I'm going to go refill my tea. And we can have a chat about the ladies in the next one. Because I think... the winner of this match is the favorite for the final. I think that's favorite to get to the final, right? So we're going to jump over there in two shakes of a whatever. And we can talk about Kyrgios, all that stuff at the start of that one. Fritz, by the way, still battling against Kubla, trying to get one back for the Americans on this Independence Day. But happy 4th of July. If we're not going to see you again, happy 4th of July. Hopefully you have a safe one. And having a good time out there. I know that we have a good time when we have public holidays and days off. So I'm sure that you are having a beer. Have one for me. I can't drink on stream, but have one for me. And God bless America or whatever. I don't know what you guys say, but you know what I mean. Celebrate on my behalf. I'm going to keep celebrating with tennis. With the ladies coming up next. As Kyrgios wins in five. We didn't get bingo, but we got another chance in the next round to possibly get bingo. And it was a five setup. 4-6, 6-4, 7-6, 3-6, 6-2. The circus rolls on into the quarterfinals against Garin.